that made more sense for the Lakers. We'll see you on ESPN2. Time for College Hoops.
Gonzaga fans have been on hold a day and a half outside McCarthy Athletic Center in Tent City. But the wait is over. One of the loudest venues in the country opens one of college basketball's premier regular season events. Welcome inside the Kennel and the tip-off marathon. Welcome to ESPN's coverage of the Old Spice Classic, part of the tip-off marathon. This electric crowd has been a major factor in the Zags only losing 7 games in 7 years in this building. Tonight's bout with West Virginia, the first of 16 over the next 24 hours on the ESPN Network. Hi, everybody. Alongside Sean Barnum, I'm Dave Pasch. No sleep till Wednesday for you, buddy. I know you've been watching all the games over the next 24 hours. What are you looking forward to most?
Well, you're going to see some great teams, but you're going to see some great individual talent as well. 7 preseason Wooden Award candidates playing in the next 24 hours, including Elias Harris from Gonzaga.
And we'll talk about him a little bit later. Right now, our one-on-one segment. It's a rematch of an NCAA tournament game from last year, one that was dominated by the Zags. Sean, what has to change for West Virginia tonight?
Talking with Coach Huggins, they're going to turn the tempo up a little bit. They want to get easy looks down low. You got to look for Caligula to assert himself deep in the paint. Murray's got to be aggressive down there as well. For Gonzaga, they need to dictate the tempo like they did in March, and that starts with their guard play. Pangos and Bell Jr., not only at the offensive end, but defensively as well, slowing them down in transition and keeping the Mountaineers in a half-court set.
And joining Bell and Pangos in the starting lineup, you talked about Elias Harris, 13 points, 9 rebounds a year ago. Guy Landrietti and Sam Dower, the other starters for the Zags. And for West Virginia, Kevin Jones, Truck Bryant are gone. This team features 3 transfers. They'll all start. Staten, Humphrey, and Murray, along with the holdovers Hines and Caligula.
No need for caffeine in this environment with this fan base, though. It's going to be electric.
And West Virginia in its first year in the Big 12 Conference after 17 years in the Big East opens on offense. Here's Caligula, who last year averaged 11 points, 5 rebounds. And we have a foul inside as Harris was defending Eric Murray, the transfer from LaSalle.
And it's going to be interesting to see how this game is officiated because of both teams. They want to play inside out. So both are going to be extremely physical, chugging cutters as they cut across the middle of the lane.
Here's Staten, who is a freshman that led the Atlantic 10 in assists when he was at Dayton. He had to sit out last year as a transfer. But he's more of a pass-first point guard compared to Truck Bryant, who was mainly a shooter when he would handle it. Also played the 2. Caligula missing, threw up a brick, but got it back for the Mountaineers. Now here's Hines. That's a 3. Caligula kept it alive again. There was contact, looked like a foul, but no call. And again, the Mountaineers with possession.
An almost ideal start for the Mountaineers, getting numerous opportunities. They want to get on the offensive glass.
And Humphrey, they'll miss the 3. West Virginia, not a good shooting team. Beautiful blow by as Gary Bell got to the bucket out of bounds off of West Virginia. Well, Mark Few, the second winningest active coach in the country in winning percentage, been to the NCAA tournament every year. 5 straight NCAAs for Bob Huggins and the Mountaineers. First time that's happened in Morgantown since the 50s when Jerry West was there. Here's Pangos, who last year in this event, the tip-off marathon, had a coming-up party as a freshman with 33 points, hit 9 threes in that game. Here's Harris, gets past Caligula. Dower there and had it blocked, but a foul call. As Humphrey went for the rejection, picked up the personal.
Dower able to slide on in because Murray had to come over and block the shot attempt. And when he slid over, created a gap, and Dower, very good hands, very quick with his release, the lefty, They're going to count on to step up a lot this year with Robert Sacre being gone now with the Los Angeles Lakers.
Actually get a foul to Kolichla. And for West Virginia, you mentioned Sacre, he's the only starter that is not back for Gonzaga, and the Zags have some depth. We'll talk about it throughout the night, but one of the guys we'll see shortly is a freshman from Poland, Szymek Karnowski, who's a three-point shooter, as well as a good player underneath, and the Zags have a lot of weapons. 19th ranked team in the country. Did not win the WCC, though, last year. A streak of 11 consecutive regular season titles ended. That was the second longest in history behind UCLA, 13 straight. Good possession down low, and Eric Murray scores for West Virginia.
And a beautiful entry pass by Humphrey, finding Murray's target hand, allowing him to go right into the hoop.
Here's Dower, and tough shot there. Double team, good defense by West Virginia. And the Mountaineers in transition. Hines with a shot that won't fall on the backside board for Eddie. They're really going to get out on Pangos when he catches behind the arc. And another West Virginia foul as DeLandrietti will go to the free throw line.
For West Virginia to be successful, they got to get the ball down low. Great pin and seal down low on the baseline by Murray. Target hand out. Humphrey identifying where that hand was and delivering a pinpoint accurate pass.
Hines picked up the foul. And so Eddie at the free throw line.
DeLandrietti did a lot of work in the weight room in the offseason. He was a guy that battled some consistency issues a year ago for the Bulldogs, but in the weight room this offseason, he got up to about 220 pounds, so tight that he actually stopped working out because he was putting on too much weight. But they looked for production out of their small forward position, something that they lacked consistency at a year ago.
Got the second free throw. And less than 2 minutes in, we are tied at two. And full court pressure now by Gonzaga. And a dangerous pass that picked off by Pangos. The drive and kick to Bell. Bell into the lane. A tip won't go from Harris. Harris got it back. Got it stripped now. And a jump ball called. It will stay Gonzaga ball. How about the pressure defensively by the Zags to force the giveaway?
The Zags showed that against Southern Utah in their tune-up game coming into this contest. And what they really want to do is really force West Virginia to play in that half-court set. But Kolichla's got to be a little tougher with that ball and recognize that Pango's got great speed and ability to react and steal that pass.
You know, this place was so on fire. And both teams are combined 1 of 10. You got to think nerves. You know, a lot of these West Virginia players, they're not used to playing this kind of atmosphere. They've been playing in a lot of NBA size arenas in the Big East Conference. And then you've got players that have transferred for some Atlantic 10 schools that maybe haven't played in a game of this magnitude before. As Staten picks up the foul, that's three quick fouls on West Virginia.
An opportunity to understand adverse situations going on the road. Everybody's against you. How do you handle that? Of course, Coach Huggins' team, you know they're going to be tough and physical.
Pangos with a three. He hit 40% of his three-point shots a year ago.
And 50% inside this building on the season for him.
He was the newcomer of the year in the WCC. From the elbow, Staten won't get it. That looked like it hit the foot of Eddie, and it did. It'll stay West Virginia ball.
Well, what you're going to notice is the left-hand side of your screen. Dower just absolutely levels. I believe it was Hines and opened up the three-point shot for Pangos.
Humphrey lost the ball as he collided with DeLandrietti. Dower will try a long-range shot that won't go. And rebounded by Matt Humphrey, a transfer from Boston College. He's got to be one of few in the history of this game to play at three different Division I schools. He transferred from Oregon to BC and then to West Virginia.
Well, you think about that, it was the Pac-10 at that time, then to the ACC, and now to the Big 12. I mean, it's not just transferring three schools. They're all power
BCS schools. Yep. He'll take a seat. West Virginia getting some subs in early. Keep Miles into the game. He started 30 games a year ago. Kolichla on the bench early. Now so far, turnovers and poor shooting, a problem for West Virginia. More turnovers than points so far for the Mountaineers.
The good news is it's been a pretty slow start offensively for Gonzaga outside of the three-pointer from Pangos.
Contact in the lane and a blocking foul is called. That's the 14th foul of West Virginia. This one in Kevin Noreen. And if you're Bob Huggins, you're in discovery mode right now, right? I mean, you don't even know what you have. You've been practicing in those transfers. They were able to practice last year, but now you're getting in game action in a state you've never played in and in a venue you've never seen before.
And identifying roles. You know, at practice, sometimes it's easy to go through the motions and learning the offense, learning the system, but it's understanding those roles and what role you'll have when the lights come on like they do tonight.
Another West Virginia foul. Two quick ones on Noreen. Fifth on West Virginia in 3.5 minutes. So here's the guys we're talking about. We mentioned the fact that Humphrey was at Oregon, then at BC, Staten at Dayton, Eric Murray at LaSalle, terrific shot blocker as a sophomore 2 years ago.
And why those numbers are important, as you mentioned, Truck Bryant, Kevin Jones no longer here.
Pangos one of three from behind the arc, but an offensive rebound for Dower. Now Pangos putting it on the floor. Michael Hart into the game. Bell's three won't go, but good hustle by Hart to get the offensive rebound. Dower, no. And finally, West Virginia control.
Well, West Virginia, I'd settle it down right here. I know you want to get out and run, but you don't have numbers in that situation. They're lucky to get bailed out by that foul.
It's on Hart, second foul. So we've had seven fouls so far called here and a total of 7 points in less than 4 minutes. Second on Gonzaga. And in comes Karnowski, the freshman from Poland, who scored 22 points in Gonzaga's season opener against Southern Utah. The Zags playing a game. West Virginia has only played exhibition contests. Here's a three-pointer that Brown misfires. Loose ball underneath, and Gonzaga has possession. West Virginia just one of seven in the early going. Eddie on the drive, got the screen from Karnowski. And another West Virginia foul. Six fouls in 4 minutes. Eric Murray picking up the personal. Gonzaga with an early three-point lead.
Have you ever found yourself in a situation where you say to yourself, this is bad. This is a negative situation. We all have. But when you believe in yourself, you'll find that it's those very situations that make you stronger. And someday, you'll look back and think, that was the best thing that ever happened to me. Guaranteed.
See you at work.
The Infiniti Limited Engagement Winter Event. Enjoy the best offers of the season, including an Infiniti G sedan for only $319 a month. Infiniti, inspired performance.
Why not make lunch more than just lunch? With 2 times the points on dining in restaurants, you may find yourself asking, why not? A lot. Chase Sapphire Preferred. There's more to enjoy.
Wednesday, it's Grizzlies Thunder and Heat Clippers on ESPN.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Old Spice Champion. Believe in your smelf. And in part by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance.
A lot of the Gonzaga fans going to need that deodorant after sleeping in these tents for the last day and a half. Where's yours, Farnham?
Mine was right next to the Davenport Hotel.
Gonzaga with the early lead. We promise it will get better here at the tip-off marathon. Slow start. Gonzaga 1 of 11, West Virginia 1 of 7, 8 fouls and 7 points have been scored so far.
Now, this is a game that has no rhythm and no flow to it whatsoever, partially because of the missed opportunities, but mainly because of the fouls. And Coach Huggins is starting to work this officiating crew and discuss the fact that his team has 6 fouls in just over 4 minutes of play. And it's going to be a physical game. We mentioned that off the top. Both teams want to get after it down low. They're going to attack the offense and defensive glass, so you're going to have some bodies hitting each other.
Pangos on the bench right now. He's got the only field goal for Gonzaga. Heading second trip at the free throw line, junior from Paris. Gonzaga traditionally with players from all over the world on their roster. Karnowski from Poland. Even Elias Harris from Germany. Long rebound after the missed free throw to West Virginia.
And I think if you're West Virginia, you've got to feel pretty good right now. You've not shot the ball well. You've got some foul issues going on early in this contest, and yet you're only down by 4 points. So it's not like Gonzaga's been able to separate at all here in the early stages.
Karnowski picks up a foul, third on Gonzaga. All right, Sean, is this a case of the officials being a little too careful, or are these good calls?
I think it's a little bit of the officials trying to be a little bit too careful, understanding both teams' philosophies. Maybe they're anticipating a little bit, but some of this contact's got to go a little bit.
It's 9 fouls in 4 minutes. Last touch by Gonzaga, good hustle by Hart. West Virginia maintains possession. Juwan Staten, sophomore point guard, 3 years of eligibility left after transferring from Dayton. Kalichla defended by Karnowski. Here's Miles in the corner. And West Virginia more patient here on this possession, taking time off the shot clock, trying to get a good look.
Some good ball reversal action, making the defense shift side to side. That was a point of emphasis yesterday for Coach Huggins.
Here's Miles, 4-3. Long rebound, Miles, and a foul. The fourth on Gonzaga. And that's David Stockton Johnson who picks up the personal. His first.
Good execution, a wide open look from the outside. Miles has got to knock that down, but to his credit, he stuck with the play and re-secured the possession.
Well, Kalichla has position on Bell, but they couldn't get it inbounds. And a turnover call. Staten was trying to call timeout, but they did not give it to him. It was a 5-second violation prior to the timeout.
Well, Dave, you saw the mismatch down low. Bell on Kalichla. Problem was they couldn't get it over the top of the person defending the ball.
Bell too strong, but Eddie tracks down the loose ball. Combined 2 of 20 shooting so far here in the first 5 minutes. Ball poked free, and now Staten out of there with it. He'll take it in 1-on-2 and then pull it out. Staten went baseline, and Hart picked up his second foul. That's the 15th foul on Gonzaga.
In a game like this, if the officials are going to continue to call things tight, and that was a good call on the baseline there, but if they're going to call it tight, then you've got to be even that much more aggressive at the offensive end of the floor and put the pressure on your defense.
Kalichla traveled. Another West Virginia turnover. That's the 5th giveaway by the Mountaineers here in 5 minutes. Elias Harris back on the floor for Gonzaga, replacing Eddie. Stockton picked up by Brown. And the pass knocked away, but Bell able to track it down before it crosses the midcourt line. From the corner, Hart is open. And it's 9-2. Bulldog.
Not noted for his offensive scoring ability. Mike Hart does a lot of those little things out on the floor, but a nice job there being ready on the catch to step into a three.
Another West Virginia turnover. 6th turnover by the Mountaineers. and an 8-0 Zags run over the last 4 minutes. And what did Bob Huggins say yesterday at practice? If we turn it over, we have no shot.
And 6 turnovers, as you mentioned earlier, and a lot of these are unforced errors. I mean, that's just misreading, miscommunication with the recipient of the pass.
And we've got an issue with the shot clock. The clock above the basket on the other end is working. The officials will try to get this ironed out.
You know, going back to just taking care of the ball, valuing the basketball, and that was one of the things that Coach Huggins discussed after their final tune-up against Glanville State. He mentioned that he did not feel comfortable with the way that they took care of the ball. They were too loose with it, and right now they're too loose in this environment. And if you get loose in a place like this and allow Gonzaga to start to build some momentum, digging yourself out of a hole becomes that much more difficult.
West Virginia, no points the last 4.5 minutes. The only bucket coming inside by Eric Murray. Gonzaga with 2 field goals, both threes, and then 3 of 6 at the free throw line. And the officials talking with both head coaches, letting them know they're going to use just the 1 clock in front of the Gonzaga bench above that basket for time and shot clock as well. So this will make it more difficult on the Gonzaga offense this half.
Zone defense, and the change in the defense by the Mountaineers.
Bell, and it's swatted away by Eric Murray, who had 73 blocks as a sophomore at LaSalle.
Almost another turnover by the Mountaineers.
Aaron Brown on the floor for West Virginia's. Harris hit the deck, and Murray with the jumper won't go. Calixto trying to battle. And Stockton out of there with it for the Zags. Karnowski posting up. And lucky for Gonzaga, that went off a West Virginia player. Harris looked at Karnowski and said, no, don't try to bounce that pass in there.
Karnowski's got a great sense about him and is really an excellent passer, but that time he was a little too unselfish, and that's what Harris was telling him. Go ahead and shoot the ball there. I've got weak side rebounding position. Have faith in yourself.
He was deep enough, right, Sean?
No question with his size. It's 7'1", 305 pounds. You put yourself down low on the block, go ahead and give that left-handed hook shot.
Here's Pangos right in front of Huggins. Murray's his second three. The only field goals for the Zags have come on triples, and they lead by 10. West Virginia's gone more than 5 minutes without a point. 11 straight during that span for the Zags. That's a push-off, another turnover. Second foul on Staten. And the 7th West Virginia turnover.
Kevin Pangos, how do you get open? You deliver the ball to the corner, sneak out the backside, a good screen by Elias Harris, delays just enough. Humphrey couldn't get there, and Pangos able to knock down the shot.
Pangos, a sophomore from Canada. Averaged 13.5 points per game a year ago. Hit 9 threes in that game against Washington State. 33 points in the tip-off marathon last year. Harris finds Dower. And now Bell from the corner. That's the only place on the court where Gonzaga's made a shot. That left side, mainly in the corner, and it's 15-2.
3-point shots. A big reason why Gonzaga got off to a great start in their NCAA matchup, and it's doing it once again. And that time, great inside-out look by Sam Dower. They got the ball down low, immediately find the shooters on the outside.
And a foul before the shot on Bell for reaching in. That's his first. And the sixth on the Zags. West Virginia has gone 6 minutes without a point. The Zags have four field goals in the game. They've all been threes. Two by Pangos.
Did you bring it, Grandpa?
I've got it, sweetie. 40-year-old tradition to keep. I hope we make it.
We'll make it.
Winter is the season to bring family together. Visit the Infiniti Limited Engagement Winter event for the best offers of the season, including an Infiniti JX for $499 a month. Infiniti, inspired performance.
If you've ever waded through a sea of tools looking for the right wrench, check this out. Craftsman Universal, innovation that lets you do more with fewer tools. Notice the universal tooth design. It handles six different types of fasteners: hex, 12-point, square, external torx, spline, and partially rounded hex. The black matte finish and high contrast markings make it easy to grab the right tool for the job. One set of tools, all types of fasteners, every kind of job. Plus, they're backed by the Craftsman Lifetime Guarantee. These just might become your favorite tools. Right now, the 56-piece set is priced at just $79.99. Now, also available, the 19-piece Universal Max Access set with pass-through design, just $39.99. It goes where standard and deep sockets can't. Smaller sets starting at just $12.99. So hurry into Sears. Visit us online at sears.com/innovation or call to take advantage of these great deals. Craftsman, guys' favorites, guaranteed.
Welcome back to Spokane. We are in hour number one and game one of 16 of the Tip-Off Marathon, the fifth annual of College Hoops Tip-Off Marathon. Coverage including games from five different time zones, 14 states. Some great games tomorrow night. Defending champion Kentucky barely escaping against Maryland on Friday night, facing Duke. From Michigan State trying to bounce back after a loss to UConn against Kansas at 7 Eastern time. Now, this is a rematch, so to speak, of an NCAA tournament game from March 15th. 7-10 matchup. Gonzaga the 7th seed, and Gary Bell and Kevin Pangos teamed up for 27 points. And West Virginia, like tonight, couldn't shoot, 32% from the field, and the Zags won big, 77-54. And so far tonight, it's Bell and Pangos again. Pangos with two threes. Bell just hit one prior to commercial, and the Zags have gone on a 14-0 run over the last 6 minutes. Sean, what has to change for West Virginia above the obvious putting into the basket?
Well, it goes back to what we said off the top in our one-on-one. You got to find some easy looks, and right now the tempo has been completely dictated, partially because of fouls, but mainly because of the aggressive nature of Gonzaga. West Virginia has not been able to get a clean look for Kalichla down low on the block yet in this contest.
Part of that is West Virginia to blame, and some of that is good defense by Gonzaga. And Kalichla having trouble even getting a catch. Case in point, poked free by Harris. Three on two, Bell gets the bucket, and it's 17-2. West Virginia quickly up the court, and a blocking foul. As the defender was moving, Brown tried to take it in on Stockton, who picked up his second foul.
Stockton with the punch out. Harris is playing the D. Bell with the finish at the other end. The Zags can get up the floor in a hurry. And if you turn it over, you're feeding the Bulldogs.
17 foul. Both teams are in the bonus lead. They called that a shooting foul. So two free throws for Gary Brown, 66% free throw shooter last year.
And he had a great game in the tournament, 15 points against Gonzaga. And so you're looking for offense right now. You're looking for guys that'll step up, be aggressive, and be able to finish. And maybe Brown will channel some of those 15 points from a year ago to kind of spark the offense.
Lichla out. West Virginia's played nine guys already, and some have been in and out of the lineup multiple times. Lichla included. Both free throws go. 17-4, Gonzaga.
Gonzaga started cold, 1 of 12, but the Zags have made their last four. And a turnover by Gonzaga as Dower tried to save it. Hines, tough shot, but got it to go.
A great job, though, by Brown, saving that ball in bounds, immediately getting his head up the court, and that's some of those easy looks that I was talking about. Get a stop defensively, start building confidence at that end of the floor.
Brown was defending Pangos and grabbed the hold of his uniform, so Brown picks up the fouls first. That's going to put Pangos at the line.
You can see Brown, though, immediately throws it ahead. Hines, a nice finish. Great hands and the athleticism. And those transition looks is something they talked about after that game in the NCAA tournament. Playing faster this year, getting out in transition, and that's really the first time we've seen it so far.
That's a new world for West Virginia as Pangos is at the line for a 1-1. The Mountaineers in the Big 12, their first conference game January 5th against Oklahoma. They're picked sixth in conference. No players named all Big 12 preseason. How do you think they'll fare in this new league, Sean?
Well, I think they're going to get better as the season goes on. And that's one of the things Coach Huggins mentioned earlier today when we were talking to him. With the transfers, defining roles, it's going to be a process. But what he expects out of his team is that they're going to play tough. They're going to be physical, and they're going to grind it out at the defensive end of the floor. And that's always been the makeup of Coach Huggins' team. And right now, West Virginia has had the punch taken to them a little bit in the early stages of this game.
Zags lead it 19-6 midway through the first half. Three-pointer way off the mark from Aaron Brown. And it's Gonzaga ball.
When you look at the Big 12 this year, obviously Kansas, once again, the preseason pick. Baylor off to a good start, and West Virginia start tonight, anything but great.
Eight turnovers and two field goals for West Virginia here early on. And a turnover by Gonzaga as the pass was picked off by Murray, and then Hines didn't see it, hit him in the head. Nine turnovers by West Virginia. Dower. And a blocking foul on Harris as Aaron Brown took it to the basket. Eighth foul on the Zags, second on Harris.
Turnovers leading to offense for the Gonzaga Bulldogs. Pangos has his head up, finds Dower over the top. Dower showing some toughness going through the contact, able to finish at the rim. 21-6 start, and Dower, the most aggressive move we've seen out of him so far in this game, and he's a guy that can score in a hurry.
Brown misses the first free throw. Shot just 50% from the foul line last year.
Well, you look at the free throw numbers with Bryant and Jones gone from a year ago for West Virginia. They combined to shoot 78% from the free throw line. The rest of the team shot just 56% from the free throw line. So an area of concern that has to improve.
And you're losing 37 points per game. Plus Jones was a terrific rebounder, 11 boards per game. And Jones was one of their better shooters too. He could sink it for three-point land as Humphreys back on the floor replacing the foul shooter Brown.
And when you make baskets, it allows you to set up your defense, and right now we're seeing West Virginia extend out their defense trying to get into the Gonzaga Bulldogs, and the only way they're going to be able to do that, Dave, is by making baskets, scoring points.
They only got 7 in 10 minutes. Pangos trying to drive on Brown and the angle cut off along the baseline. Eddie with a blow by. Gets into the lane. Beautiful move by Guy Landry Eddie. 4 points for him. Back to a 16-point lead for the Bulldogs. Miles hits the cutter, and Hines able to catch and flip it off the window quickly.
A quick, beautiful finish by Hines underneath.
And a reach-in foul on Humphrey. 19 foul in West Virginia. First on Humphrey. A 1-1 situation here for Gonzaga, which is starting to heat up from the field and also at the free throw line getting opportunities for points with the clock stop.
And some frustration for West Virginia, and Humphrey goes to the bench.
Yeah. So Eddie with the front end of the 1-1.
It was a tough year for Eddie last year to try to find himself in a rhythm and a flow. He couldn't play for the first 8 games of the season because of playing professionally when he was 15 and 16 years old. But after coming back from that, he just didn't find himself in a rhythm this year. Spending more time, being able to get to the practices early, makes a world of difference for a player.
His experience certainly last year will help this year. And again, Gonzaga with a lot of depth. Also, you have Kelly Olynyk. We talk about the situation with Eddie last year as the 3 won't go. Olynyk suspended the first 3 games of this season. He'll be available for Gonzaga here in a week or so as West Virginia gives it away. There's Olynyk.
Made the Canadian national team over the course of the summer. And when talking with Mark Few, I asked him what player has improved the most from last year to this year, and he said Kelly Olynyk. When you look at the talent that's out on the floor right now, you can see why expectations are at an all-time high here in Spokane.
Now you got a couple 7-footers, and then you have these great shooters on the perimeter like Pingos, and then you have a slasher in Eddie, who's short with that one, and then a reach-in foul on Hart. That's 3 on him. Well, you talked about the expectations for Gonzaga. Zags 19th in the country coming in, and obviously high expectations for these 4 teams. Michigan State trying to bounce back after losing to UConn. They'll play Kansas in the State Farm Champions Classic tomorrow at 7. Then they got Duke, Kentucky at 9 Eastern. Duke ranked 9th, Kentucky 3rd. Are the Zags in the class of those 4 teams that we'll see tomorrow night?
Potentially, yes, and that's obviously a dangerous word, but this is, everybody around this program says it's the closest team that they've had in a very long time. They really genuinely like being around each other. And you mentioned the size, the versatility that Mark Few has with this lineup. They're a team that, come March, could be ready to make a push for a Final Four. They're that good of a team. I mean, you look at Kentucky right now, last year was such a special year with that group of freshmen. So unselfish, not only at the offensive end, but also the defensive end, and how committed they were to getting stops and rebounding the basketball.
Got a whole new team, though, in Kentucky, yeah, with all those guys in the NBA.
Well, they were out-rebounded by 12 versus Maryland and gave up 23 offensive rebounds. And taking on Duke as part of the tip-off marathon, they're going to have to figure out a way to keep Mason Plumlee off the glass. Plumlee had 19 and 14 in the opener for the Blue Devils.
Gary Brown just picked up another foul, so Gonzaga's in the double bonus for the remainder of the half. 2 free throws for Pangos. Pangos with 8 points already, couple of threes. Pangos last year shot 85% at the foul line, knocks both of them down there. It's 27-11, Gonzaga. Gary Henderson.
Infinity Limited Engagement Winter Event. Enjoy the best offers of the season, including an Infiniti G sedan for only $319 a month. Infiniti, inspired performance.
I want to apologize for the technical difficulties we're having here in Spokane. Gonzaga leading by 16, 27-11. West Virginia with 10 turnovers and 11 points.
2-3 zone for the Gonzaga Bulldogs. You got to box out of the 2-3 zone. Make sure you find body. Understand the Mountaineers are going to crash.
And wow, miserable turnover there as Gary Brown picked up the pivot foot and traveled. They have as many giveaways as points here in the first half. Very physical first half between these two teams. 19 fouls have been called as the Zags are rolling in the first half at home.
Capital One Cash Rewards Card gives you 1% cash back on all purchases, plus a 50% annual bonus. And everyone but her. likes 50% more cash, but I'm up in my game.
Do you want a candy cane?
Yeah.
Do you want the puppy?
Yeah.
Do you want a tricycle?
Yes.
Do you want 50% more cash?
No.
Festive.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you 1% cash back on every purchase, plus a 50% annual bonus on the cash you earn. It's the card for people who like more cash. Mesothelioma victims and their loved ones may be entitled to a cash award from the $18 billion in asbestos trust funds. Even if a loved one had mesothelioma or asbestos lung cancer and has passed, your family may still be entitled to a cash award. Call now to see if you qualify. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, call 1-800-948-5177 now.
Battle in Seattle, Gonzaga versus Kansas State. Tickets on sale now.
Game one of the 24-hour tip-off marathon, and the Gonzaga Bulldogs up by 16 over West Virginia right now, and it has not been a pretty first half for the Mountaineers. Too many miscues here in the first half, and the turnovers, 11 of them, which equals the amount of points in which they've scored so far. But with the fouls, with the turnovers, it's allowed run-out opportunities for the Gonzaga Bulldogs, who are outscoring West Virginia 13-0 on points off of turnovers, and a big reason for their 16-point lead, aside from the shooting, 3 of 16 for West Virginia.
They had a 7-minute scoreless drought. And again, more turnovers. Obviously, in field goals and as many turnovers as points. Kalichla has been in and out of the game. See if they can get him involved and get him some touches. It's been a challenge even to get it to him in the low block because of the defense collapsing by Gonzaga.
Point of emphasis for the Gonzaga Bulldogs. We're trying to take away the interior presence of West Virginia and four shots to come from outside. They've been highly successful in that so far. You see 0 for 8 from three-point land. A lot of shots coming from those long distance.
Dower turned it over, tried to spin, and Humphreys got it ahead to Hines. And again, just a great effort trying to even get it down to the low block to Kalichla. It's knocked out of bounds by Gonzaga. You got Karnowski guarding the baseline, and then there was a foul on West Virginia on the inbound. A player control foul, so no free throws personal on Humphreys, second.
But a lost opportunity, a lost possession. Those are empty possessions. The call away from the ball. And Coach Huggins obviously not happy about that call.
Turnover number 12 by the Mountaineers here in the first half. Angles lost it as the Zags turn it over. They're having troubles of their own protecting the ball. Their seventh turnover. Now a blocking foul on Pangos as Aaron Brown took it to the hole. That's two on Pangos and a 10th team foul on the Zags.
Kevin just really loose with the ball up top. And that allowed West Virginia to get out in transition. And every time there's been a turnover when West Virginia's been in the open floor, they've made some positive things happen, whether that's getting to the free throw line like they're doing in this opportunity or scoring looks.
Aaron Brown, a sophomore, getting a lot of playing time here in the first half. He's getting to the free throw line, but unable to knock him down. He's one of three now at the stripe. One more coming here. And goes to the bench for the Zags. One out of two for Brown. 27-12, Gonzaga 7 to go here in the first.
And Stockton in control of the ball. And that's going to allow, again, West Virginia to set up their defense, try to pressure Gonzaga and get them out of a rhythm and flow. After their cold start, they heated up. And that started a lot from the perimeter, but then they were able to dump the ball down low. Find guys up over the top.
Stockton picked up by Staten, or make that Hines on defense. State defending Bell. Dower setting the screen. And Bell looking for Karnowski, but Kalich LaFrenic.
One of the best possessions we've seen so far defensively for West Virginia.
Shot clock at 7. And it's rare we've seen the Zags take a shot with time running down on the shot clock. And they get a good one. Dower was open and with 2 on the timer. He hits it.
You work hard, but then you lunge and reach and get yourself out of position. And that's what allowed Dower to have the wide open look from the free throw line.
Got to be frustrating for Bob Huggins. You go 33 seconds of playing good defense in that possession. Kalichla fouled by Karnowski, and he'll shoot 2. Second on Karnowski. Again, both teams have a double bonus.
In that last possession, Dower sets the screen up top. Doesn't even really make a lot of contact, but watch the flyby by Staten. And that flyby is what allowed Dower to have a clean look at the hoop. So even with the defense collapsing and going to Stockton, if Staten just checks up and contests the shot, gives yourself a better opportunity.
And Kalich with a way off of the first. Coming up on Wednesday, got an NBA doubleheader starting in Oklahoma City. The Red Hot Grizzlies have won 5 in a row, just beat the Heat the other night. That's at 8, and then the Clippers and Heat at 10:30 from Los Angeles. It all starts with Kia NBA Countdown at 7.
Of course, you'll be in Oklahoma City for that game against the Memphis Grizzlies. A lot of fun to watch the Thunder go. They get up and down the floor.
At Durant, Westbrook, OKC. In a learning phase without James Harden, and West Virginia in discovery mode as well. What's harder if you're the Mountaineers and you've got a new nucleus, offense or defense?
I think it comes at the offensive end of the floor. Defense is about effort. When you play for Coach Huggins, you got to extend out, pressure the ball, and make plays.
Karnowski had an easy one. He couldn't make it, but he was fouled, and will go to the line.
Offense comes a little bit more difficult when you're trying to identify where a person wants the ball passed to them, how they want it delivered to them, where they're most successful in scoring. And when you have a couple of transfers, even though they've been around the program, it does still add an element of, hey, this is going to take some time to find our rhythm and flow.
And the 7'1" freshman from Poland, Szymek Karnowski, at the free throw line. This certainly will be a player to watch in the WCC this year, and then perhaps nationally as well. Coaches want him to get in better shape.
But he's got great touch, great size. He played for the U19 Polish team in the World Championships, and a very talented young man.
Missed both free throws. Hart knocked it out, but into the hands of West Virginia, and then State misfires in the pull-up J. West Virginia shooting 19% from the field. Bell on the drive, floater, able to knock it down off glass. The lead is 19, and 7 points now for Gary Bell.
2-3 zone for the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
Humphrey will rise, way off from 3, West Virginia 0-9 from behind the arc. Another 3-point try won't go for Hines, and cleared by Karnowski. An open 3. It's good.
Every Italian family has their own treasured recipes. And this holiday season at Carrabba's, we're serving up 2 favorites on 1 plate. Like our wood-grilled sirloin, topped with handmade marsala sauce and served alongside our signature chicken Brian ravioli. Or enjoy layers of flavor grilled over a wood fire with our Pollo Rosa Maria and chicken involtini. These dishes are only here for a short time, so find your favorite tonight and come home to Carrabba's. And now, when you purchase $100 in gift cards, you'll get a $20 bonus card free.
Game one of the tip-off marathon, and Gary Bell, after a solid freshman campaign, is starting off his sophomore year with no slump. Driving to the hoop, showing the versatility and the range from the outside, and the sophomore's got 10. And the Gonzaga Bulldogs up big, and you see the difference in 3-point field goals. 5 of 9 for Gonzaga and an 0 for the Mountaineers.
And a 7-0 run by Gonzaga over the last minute 50. 34-12. Gonzaga leads, 4:40 on the clock here in the first half. Bell and Pangos with 10 points apiece to lead Gonzaga. Hines and Murray with 4 apiece for West Virginia. Finally, a 3-ball goes as Henderson knocks it down, a freshman from Raleigh, North Carolina.
That just stops it momentarily. Now you got to try to string together stops at the defensive end of the floor.
That's not a stop. That's an easy one for Hart. As West Virginia fell asleep on defense, and that'll make Bob Huggins more angry than the missed shots on the other end.
No excuse to allow a player to stand directly underneath the hoop and be unaccounted for.
Stockton almost with a steal. And a jump ball call that will stay West Virginia ball, according to the alternate possession arrow. There's John watching his son. You got to be happy with what he's seen so far. Gonzaga right now leading by 21. David Stockton, beautiful look, but Hart was wide open.
College basketball is back on ESPN with the State Farm Champions Classic. Four of the nation's premier programs rumble in Atlanta. First, returning big man Jeff Withey leads powerhouse Kansas against the stacked Michigan State squad. Then two heavyweight coaches go head-to-head when Coach K's Blue Devils take on the defending national champion Wildcats. The State Farm Champions Classic. Michigan State, Kansas at 7 Eastern. Duke, Kentucky at 9. Tonight on ESPN.
You hear that? That's the sound of car insurance companies these days. Here a cheap, there a cheap, everywhere a cheap. You get it. So what if instead of just a cheap choice, you could make a smart choice? Like Esurance, for example. They were born online and built to save people money from the beginning. That's what they've always done. Not just something they cheap about. That's insurance for the modern world. Esurance, now backed by Allstate. Click or call.
Hey, man, I'd like to trade this game in.
$9.
$9?
Sorry, we just can only give you $9.
Come on, man.
That's our policy, sorry.
The game costs 60. No, I don't want a coupon.
Don't get ripped off again. Play games before you buy them with over 8,000 console titles to choose from. Go to Gamefly.com, click the joystick, enter game, and get 1 month free.
Gamefly, before you buy.
Join now, play hundreds of PC games, and get your first month free. Product shown rated E through M.
I'm Carl Ravitch on the UPS Halftime Report. Obviously, deep now into the tip-off marathon, 24 hours of college basketball, highlighted by these two huge games on ESPN featuring four of the top teams in the country. Good chance to see Baylor. Brittany Griner's back again, 6 Eastern on ESPN2. We'll have highlights of Indiana, number one team in the land. Jay Williams and Seth Greenberg, the pregame speeches he gave to inspire. You'll hear it at the half.
All right, Ravi, they're rocking here at Gonzaga with the Bulldogs leading by 21 in hour one of the fifth annual tip-off marathon. Easy buckets right now for Gonzaga, Sean.
And it starts with fundamentals. Sometimes the most dangerous man on the court is the one that sets the screens. The defense is going to shift out in this area after Hart sets the screen. Watch what happens. He peels off, finds himself wide open in the center of the floor, unaccounted for. Stockton with the great court vision, finds him underneath in the easy finish.
Now Stockton last year averaged 4 points per game. And John comes to all the games. He played at Gonzaga and the all-time assist leader in the NBA and has stayed up here in the Spokane area. Very involved in the university. Murray at the free throw line, Stockton with a reach in. That was the other thing about John when he played. Not just a great assist man, but terrific defensive player. And his son pretty good, too.
Yeah, his son has gotten really talented at gambling a little bit from that weak side position, but having active hands.
Shot clock violation as West Virginia turns it over for the 14th time.
Coach Huggins pointed at the shot clock. Said it's right there, fellas. You got to have awareness.
I don't know. I've been covering West Virginia and the Big East for a lot of years, and obviously Bob Huggins is one of the best coaches in college basketball. This may be one of the bigger challenges he's had, trying to get a group with three transfers on the same page, as you see again, defensively falling asleep, and Dower getting the easy bucket. West Virginia really struggling at both ends.
Great interior pass that time by Karnowski, setting up his teammate.
Down 23 with 3 minutes to go here in the first half. Three-pointer straight on is way off from Henderson. Brown got the long rebound, though. Alexla trying to post up. Brown on the drive. Nice spin. And he banks it in.
Brown trying to push himself a little bit to get active. 4 points for him here in the first half.
Bell, Karnowski, very patient, then reverse and put it in.
And that's what people love about him up here, the poise that the freshman has. Didn't immediately try to go up through the contact, instead allowed the shot blocker to fly on by, reverse layup. Make it easy.
Used a dribble to make sure he didn't travel as well, put it in. Kalichla facing a double team, now a triple team as Stockton came down, and now a three-pointer from Braun won't go. Karnowski with the rebound. Inside two to play here in the first half. Karnowski left open again underneath. Kalichlin is late rotating and an easy bucket.
Three baskets in a row from their bigs, all underneath the hoop. Dower repaying the favor from two possessions ago, and this time he finds Karnowski down low.
Kalichla is fouled by Karnowski. That's three on him.
We talk about working the inside out, the strength of the Gonzaga Bulldogs, and it starts with great interior passing. Karnowski feels Kalichla, sees Dower wide open on the weak side. Next possession. The guards up top find Karnowski, has the patience to go to the reverse layup, and then this time Dower sees Murray come on out. Help side defense, slow rotating over Karnowski, too deep in the paint to stop them from finishing that one.
Gonzaga's made its last seven shots. Some of them have been right around the rim. Because of poor defense, as Kalichla is at the free throw line shooting two. Only 56% at the stripe a year ago. That's his first point of the game.
He averaged about 11 points per contest, just a little bit under 11 points per contest last year. And they need him to be a scoring option down low. If they're going to continue to struggle from the outside, they need to find points underneath. Just one of 13 from behind the arc in this one.
Good hustle by Brown getting the rebound off the missed free throw. Minute remaining here in the first half. Gonzaga leading by 24. With eight to shoot, and almost threw it into the stands, and he was out of bounds, they say. So Gonzaga ball.
A sloppy pass, great effort by Brown going up trying to save that one and keep it in bounds. We're going to go to the half here, and Seth Greenberg back in the studios. I wonder what Seth would say if he was coaching the Mountaineers, what he would tell them at halftime, try to inspire them to come back down.
Bell hits a three. Bell with 13 points, 3 of 4 from behind the arc.
As everything here in the first half has gone the Bulldogs' way.
15 seconds remaining in the half. Staten with seven. And got a foul called on West Virginia on Staten as Bell was going for the loose ball. So it'll be free throws with 4.3 on the clock.
And that's his third personal for Staten. And one of those fouls now with 4.3 seconds left to go. Loose ball situation.
Team control foul here, Sean. So no free throws with the loose ball there.
Bringing a couple of shooters. Barham, the transfer from Memphis, is checked into the game.
Gonzaga going to call a timeout. Mark Few is about 10 feet onto the court trying to get Jimmy Case's attention. 45-18, 4.3 remaining in the half. Sean, you and I thought that this might be a tough game for West Virginia. I don't know if anybody could have predicted this, though. Mountaineers got a long way to go.
No, and it goes back to what we talked about off the top on our one-on-one. Finding easy looks. There's been no easy looks here in the first half. Really limited for the Mountaineers. On the flip side, dictating the tempo and the flow of this game. Pangos and Bell have been able to dictate it, and mainly Bell. His hot shooting from the outside, his ability to break down the defense, has also allowed some of those bigs to get going later here in the first half.
And Bell's been outstanding, 13 points. He's got three threes in this game. Gonzaga started cold, 1 of 12. Look what they've done since. They've made 14 of their last 16 from the field. And they work all around the rim. Bell and Pangos combining for five threes during that span.
And 6 of 10 from three-point land, 60% from behind the arc here in the first half for the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
Mountaineers just 1 of 13 from the field. Almost as many turnovers as points in the first half. 15 turnovers and 18 points.
And last year during the tip-off marathon, it was Pangos that set it on fire. And right now, Jerry Bell Jr. asserting himself. Last year, maybe a little bit underrated. A great defensive player, hit the timely shot. But this year, being much more aggressive.
Not sure what the discussion is here. Perhaps a substitution there. Yep, Stockton going out.
They had subbed in Barham, and they called the timeout, and then took him back off the floor. And no time had elapsed off the clock.
I got a team control foul, so no free throws. Here's Bell with two. Bell with one, lets it fly. And that's the end of the first half. Gonzaga leading at 45-18 over West Virginia. The Zags shoot 52% from the field. West Virginia 22%. Now the UPS halftime report. Carl Ravitch.
They needed that three to fall. That would have made it 48-18. That was the UPS halftime report. Jay Will here, along with the coach, Seth Greenberg. Take a look at the number one team in the land, Cody Zeller. Had a huge night, 26-18. He went for 22-9-2. They get a little passing work in here.
Victor Oladipo drops the dime. He is the Energizer Bunny for the Hoosiers.
All right, later in the second, they're up by 26. Hollowell played some minutes.
Jeremy Hollowell, Remy Abel, two X factors for the Hoosiers this year.
They got the X, the Y. They're number one, 87-61. We saw it there. Welcome to the UPS Halftime Report. Looking forward to the season with Seth Greenberg and Jay Will here. Wow, Gonzaga looks great, or West Virginia looks terrible. What is it?
I think Gonzaga is for real. In fact, I think they're a Final Four team.
Really?
Think they're as deep a basketball team as there is in the country, for sure in the West Coast.
Okay.
This was before tonight, or just because of the first half?
No, this is because they have legitimate depth. They have legitimate size. They've got a guy like Elias Harris, who did not score in the first half.
Yeah.
Did not score a field
goal. What's the significance of that?
Well, because I think he's a special player. You're talking about his career right now. Here's a guy who's seventh in the history of Gonzaga in rebounding. Mm-hmm. 1,300 points, 78 wins. The guy is shooting 40% from the field, 52% from the two-point line. But more importantly, he plays off of everyone else. You love their backcourt, Bell and Pangos. They can make shots.
Right.
They shoot it with range. They've got great depth up front. This is a potential Final Four team.
They hung a bagel on the board in the first half, and they got all these 45 points. If they're the best in the West, they're going to the Final Four. Well, who's left out there?
Well, you know, Coach gave us a nickname. We're Salt and Pepper, right? So we always disagree. And I got Gonzaga. Wait,
how can you not agree?
I got Gonzaga.
How can you not agree?
I mean, listen, I got San Diego State, number 5, all right? I got, you know, at number 4, I have UNLV. I like UNLV.
Even though they don't have a point guard.
Even though, yeah, number four in the West for me. And then I have the Zags, number 3. Number 2, I have UCLA. And I think UCLA, if they can get Shabazz Muhammad eligible, if that ever happens, they'll be boosted up to number 1.
Right.
And then number 1, I have Arizona. I love this basketball team. Sean Miller in his 4th year. You have Solomon Hill, who lost 20 pounds. He's been working on his perimeter jump shot. Nick Johnson in that backcourt, along with Mark Lyons, who transferred over from Xavier.
Right.
I mean, I love their depth, and I love their speed, and I love the way they play.
I love Solomon.
So, and Elias Harris, I think he's a great player. I just think he has a tendency to disappear sometimes, and I question that with him.
Like tonight,
0 points.
So far.
I mean, he's been great, but tendency to disappear.
He might have disappeared, but they're up like 30. So right now, they really don't need Elias Harris.
I agree.
Recruiting for Ben Howland is going to be interesting to see how and if those freshmen do get in to play for him. Halftime report rolling along. Look at how comfortable Seth looks in that role. New role now, but we'll hear some of his pregame pep talks and what makes a team tick.
Why not make lunch more than just lunch? With 2 times the points on dining in restaurants, you may find yourself asking, why not? A lot. Chase Sapphire Preferred. There's more to enjoy.
Nothing is tougher on your car's floor than you. That's why there's WeatherTech floor liners. WeatherTech floor liners are laser measured to custom fit and perfectly protect your specific make and model. Front, back, even up the sides. Dirt and spills stay in the liner until you wash them away. Order your floor liners at EasyCleanMats.com or call 1-877-6-EASY-CLEAN. Complete protection, completely American made. Order your floor liners today at EasyCleanMats.com.
The clean energy revolution is underway. Where will the power come from to keep it going? Like all revolutions, it will depend on people. People with passion. People with innovation. People with the power to literally change the world. Clean energy jobs are out there, and we're giving people the power to go get them. Ecotech Institute, the first and only college focused on careers in renewable energy. You have the power. Make the world your workplace.
Battle in Seattle, Gonzaga versus Kansas State. Tickets on sale now.
I'm working towards comprehensive immigration reform, being the voice for those families so that they're given an opportunity to pursue their dreams.
I have the privilege of being able to champion the causes that fall through the cracks, and my job is to make sure that those people don't get overlooked.
Our goal is to build a high school where none exists, because kids in South Sudan deserve to have access to basic education.
We're Zags.
Join us.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. Let UPS put the power of logistics to work for you.
Back with Jay Wilms and the longtime 35-year head coach who's going through withdrawals tonight, Jack Greenberg, watching. Glenn Robinson III looks like Glenn Robinson the original. He's got the high socks, got the knee pads. He went 8 of 9, 21 points, 32 minutes.
He's going to be big for them at that 3-4 position. Also for Michigan, they shot 62% from the three-point line. That was a huge factor in this game.
Trey Burke, who's got the greatest name for a three-point shooter, knocks down a two-pointer there. And then John Horford had the most impressive dunk of the night. In 3 minutes of action. All right, here's what we got ahead on the College Hoops tip-off marathon, and of course, social media all over it. Hashtag tip-off marathon, and
you guys love that.
Twitter
love
that. At ESPN.
Hey, we've got John Kruk following us. Come
Kruk's
on,
following. Get out of here. Give me a game you like, exclusive of the last three on this page.
I'll tell you, I like Davidson, New Mexico. You got to stay up for that 2 o'clock game.
You like it,
Davidson with Cone and Brooks, and then New Mexico, absolute terrific
like
wild card.
I like that game. How about you?
I'm going to see, you know, Detroit and St. John's. Ray McCallum is one of the top guards in the country. I look forward to watching that.
Seth got us fired up for Davidson, New Mexico. He has spent a career getting individuals fired up to play as a team. Check it out.
Thanks, Ravi. This might be a talk a coach would give to his team prior to his opening game. I did it for 20 years. It might sound something like this. I feel really good about our basketball team. We've had an unbelievable preseason and a great first 3 weeks. This team has a chance to be special. But we've got to understand a couple things. First and foremost, the season, it's a marathon. It is not a sprint. It's 30 separate entities, and we need to be ready to play each and every night. Our approach, our attitude, our work ethic, our preparation, they need to be consistent. As you guys know, we believe in our non-negotiables. We will be the hardest playing, toughest team in college basketball. We'll own the 50-50, and for sure we're going to be first to the floor. We've got to have great team trust. We've got to believe in each other and understand that basketball is not a game of perfect. We're going to make mistakes, but we've got to get to the next play. The one thing we got to make sure, we make no excuses and we have no regrets. Offensively and defensively, we've got to be true to our principles. Defensively, great pressure on the basketball. On balance closeouts, we're going to fight through screens each and every time. Ball screen situation, we're blitzing every single ball screen. And finally, we contest the shot, physical blockouts, pursue the basketball, and then bam, we're off and running. Offensively, we attack in transition. We share the ball in transition. If we don't have early offense, we get that thing reversed. Sprint to your screens, sprint off your screens. When we reverse that basketball, let's be down and ready to shoot the thing, see a big basket, and feel good about it. When that thing goes on the glass, let's attack the offensive glass. Like I said, this team has a chance to be special. Let's believe in each other. Let's trust each other. Let's take no plays off. Let's do something special this year. I believe in you guys. You've got to believe in yourselves.
You had me at hello.
Ravi, give me a ball. I'm ready to play, coach.
Share the sugar.
Share the sugar.
That was the Jerry Maguire moment then. Dower dunking. Is West Virginia got a comeback in him? Make a basket.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. Let UPS put the power of logistics to work for you.
Everybody remembers the play. But what about the strategy? The teamwork? The execution? That is logistics. And that is what we do.
Tired of faded bumpers, foggy headlights, weathered, sun-damaged vehicles? You've spent time and money applying product again and again to hide those embarrassing parts on your car, only to have that work fade away. Not anymore. Introducing WipeNew, the world's longest-lasting solution for restoring and protecting your vehicle. And we guarantee it to last for years. Just apply WipeNew once. It's quick and easy to do. Just one swipe and watch your car turn showroom new.
I've been a professional auto detailer for 30 years. Now I restore faded plastic rather than just clean it. And I do it in no time at all. I apply WipeNew to bumpers, side panels, even dashes and interior plastic. Simply apply it once and it lasts for years. WipeNew is the most revolutionary car care product that I've used in my entire detailing career.
We applied WipeNew to the driver's side of this vehicle. We then sent this car through over 100 powerful car washes. WipeNew never faded or washed away, proving that the results will last for years of real-world environmental exposure.
I don't think I've ever seen it, Brandon. I got it about 2 years old, and I've never seen it shine like this.
And we guarantee it to last for years. Use it on bumpers, decorative outside panels, side view mirrors, even vinyl or leather car seats for a protected showroom new shine. Don't spend a fortune on temporary fixes. Order the revolutionary White New for only $19.99. But wait, order now and we'll double the size. That's enough for two cars. There's still more. Order now and get the Pro Detailing Kit with the headlight applicator bonus. Just pay separate shipping and processing. That's right, White New restores your headlights too. Order now and get it all, plus a two-year guarantee. A $50 value for only $19.99. Order now.
To get your White New detailing kit, call 1-800-577-9364. White New comes with a two-year money-back guarantee and is not available in stores. So call 1-800-577-9364 and order today.
This is the UPS Halftime Report.
Each and every halftime report, you get your headlines. Mike D'Antoni named the Lakers head coach. Our guys out here, 50-50. Jeff Gordon lost his mind yesterday, got fined $100,000. Mike Trout and Bryce Harper win their Rookie of the Year awards. We'll see if Trout wins the MVP award. As you mentioned, that's why Kruk is following us right now. He gets his baseball news. Meantime, Notre Dame got 16-9 from Jack Cooley. Irish flush Monmouth, 84-57.
Well, Robert, when I look at Notre Dame, they're right in that second category in the Big East behind Syracuse and Louisville, in my opinion.
I like that. 81-66, Memphis is a winner. Seth, you like Memphis, right?
I like Memphis. I think it can shoot the basketball. Point guard play will be the key.
Bennett goes for 22-7, gets some help from Marshall and Dejon Jones. They beat Northern Arizona 92-54. By the way, the ESPN College Basketball social media hub on fire tonight. And, well, some of them are on fire. That's Seth and Jay Will checking out the basketball games. You can tweet us at ESPNCBB, hashtag tipoffmarathon. Rumor has it it's near trending now, and they'll be there all night. All right, Huggy Bear, what are you saying to your West Virginia team that was awful in the first half?
Well, we were awful, but there are going to be 5 4-minute games in the second half, and we're going to try to win each one of those guys, chip away, hopefully at the 4-minute mark or the 8-minute mark or the 12-minute mark. We can kind of get it to the point where it's a game, and then from there, hopefully.
Now, can you be honest and say, guys, we were
not a chance. It's the first game of the season. Yeah. Hey, you know what we got to do? Coming into that 60-minute timeout, we got to get this thing under 20.
If I'm hanging, if I'm in there,
12-minute timeout, we're going to get it to under 15.
Would Huggy say it like that, though?
No, I think, you know, quite honestly, you know, my pregame talk,
yeah,
I think Huggy would have kind of filled it up with a couple other words.
A little bit more spice.
Colorful commentary.
A little bit more spice.
A little juicier.
I got you. Well, it is midnight in most places. You could probably have brought that up. Halftime report is all done. Is Gonzaga? Not yet. Gary Bell Jr., part of a 45-point onslaught. Seth's got him in the Final Four already.
Take notes on the spot. Catch every detail with Video Zoom. And now, run two apps at the same time on the same screen. The freedom to do what you want, when you want.
Let's go again.
With the quad-core powered LG Optimus G. Available from Sprint.
Where am I going? To a place where a man's success is determined not by the color of his credit card, but by the position he took on the Aussie dollar in the face of rising commodity prices. I'm going where I can trade currencies on a platform that's as smart as I am. I'm going to trade the world.
And what floor would that be on?
It's your world. Trade it at forex.com.
Forex trading involves substantial risk of loss and is not suitable for all investors.
In the nation, we can't make every annoying thing disappear. But we can eliminate deductibles. Nationwide insurance members who add vanishing deductible get $100 off for every year of safe driving. We put members first because we don't have shareholders. Join the nation where deductibles go.
Nationwide is on your side.
Our decisions affect every person in the state of Washington. We need to approach each case with the concern and dedication that it deserves.
When President Obama was elected, I was asked to serve the administration. Being able to answer the call for all the U.S. territories, from the Pacific or the Caribbean, was important to me.
Refugees from war, the homeless, the poor, and uninsured. The focus of our mission is to care for those people.
We are ZAGS.
Join us.
Volkswagen is Das Auto. University Volkswagen is Das People. Our friendly sales and service professionals offer outstanding selection and comprehensive customer protection with University's exclusive passport service. University Volkswagen, an ownership experience beyond your expectation. Because nobody gives you more.
A University Volkswagen.
Just off I-5 and at universityvw.com.
ESPN's coverage of the Old Spice Classic, part of continuing coverage of the Tip-Off Marathon from the Kendall McCarthy Athletic Center in Spokane. Hour number two of the Tip-Off Marathon. 15 games and one half to go on the ESPN networks. Gonzaga rolling 45-18. Dave Pass with Sean Farnham. Gonzaga started the game 1-for-12, and its best player didn't score. Yet the Zags lead by 27. What happened?
Well, it was just explosive offense. They started turning it over for West Virginia. That allowed for easy runouts, and the perimeter shooting of Gonzaga really got them ignited. In the first half overall, 6 of 11 from behind the arc. Pangos had two of them. Then Gary Bell Jr. attacking the rim, slicing up the defense, stretching it out from the outside. A couple of 8 three-pointers for him as well. Screen, pick and pop. They had their way, and now West Virginia has got to rebound. There's two things I look at here. How competitive and how much fight are we going to see out of the Mountaineers in the second half? And how much attention to detail can we get out of the Gonzaga Bulldogs? Can they handle this lead and still execute the way they did down the stretch on the first half?
West Virginia's last game was against Gonzaga in the NCAA tournament last year. The Zags won that game by 23. They led by 18 at the half in that game, 40-22. Good start defensively to this half for the Mountaineers, who had just 5 baskets in the first half and allowed Gonzaga to shoot 52% from the field. Nice move along the baseline there by Eric Murray.
Well, the second time in this game, we've seen an easy entry pass down low and a nice finish, and both times it's come to the hands of Murray.
Knocked out of bounds, but a foul is called. That's on Humphrey, and that's his third personal. There were 25 fouls called in the first half.
And 13 to 12. So balance within those fouls. The early fouls, though, I really think disrupted West Virginia's approach and their flow to the game.
Bell to the basket. There was contact. And Harris is there. His first points of the game. Last year, 13 points per contest. He's on the Wooden Award preseason list for the third straight year.
And they start the second half in the 2-3 zone for the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
Here's Hines from up top. Knocks down a three. That's 7 points for Hines. Eddie back up court, can't drop it in.
That was a rushed look. No need for that one.
Three-pointer won't go for Humphrey, but able to track it down is Murray. Staten fakes the pass, takes the long two, and up high is Harris for the rebound. Harris pushing the tempo, lost it, but it ends up in Pangos' hands. Pangos had 10 points in the first half as Harris puts up an air ball.
A couple of ugly rushed possessions for the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
How do you keep the intensity if you're Gonzaga when you've got a 27-point lead at halftime.
The great teams will do it, and the ones that understand the way that Coach Huggins' teams will execute in the second half.
West Virginia with a turnover, had 15 in the first half. Good save by Bell. Keep it from going out of bounds. Nice cut. And Pangos unable to get the basket, but he's fouled. That's two quick ones on West Virginia in the half, and Hines is second personal.
Now what happens a couple possessions ago, Elias Harris finally gets on the board. Watch the drive. He kind of seals off Kalichla. Murray comes over if he's going to block the shot, but he vacates his spot, and that allows Harris to get the easy finish.
And a timeout called by Bob Huggins early in the second half. His team down 47-23.
The Ford EcoBoost 400 at Homestead Miami, Sunday at 1:30 on ESPN.
Hey, man, I'd like to trade this game in.
$9.
$9?
Sorry, but just can only give you $9.
Come on, man.
That's our policy. Sorry.
The game costs $60. No, I don't want a coupon.
Don't get ripped off again. Play games before you buy them with over 8,000 console titles to choose from. Go to Gamefly.com, click the joystick, enter game, and get 1 month free.
Gamefly, before you buy.
Join now. Play hundreds of PC games and get your first month free. Product shown rated EQM.
This is Joe Wood's first day of work, and his new boss told him two things. Cook what you love and save your money. Joe doesn't know it yet, but he'll work his way up from busser to waiter to chef before opening a restaurant specializing in fish and game from the great Northwest. He'll start investing early. He'll find some good people to help guide him, and he'll set money aside from his first day of work to his last, which isn't rocket science. It's just common sense. From TD Ameritrade.
Buying concert tickets the day they go on sale? Think you're at the front of the line? Not so fast.
It's really nerve-wracking to think, like, what if you can't get a ticket?
I'll show you how to make sure you get the seats you want tonight at 11 on King 5 News.
This pox-scarred warrior? High-tech? No. But helping Northwest pilots navigate unfriendly skies to keep you safer. Imagine no more turbulence, lightning, or hail. It's coming thanks to what's on board this whole plane. Tonight at 11, King 5 News.
We always wanted a big two-story house.
Everyone has a job to do. And we build a GMC for everyone.
We wanted fame and fortune.
Now get 0% financing for 60 months on the 2012 GMC Terrain.
We knew somehow we'd make it. Together, me and you.
24 hours and 16 games across five time zones of college basketball. The journey to the tourney, the upcoming schedule, State Farm Champions Classic tonight. Depending on where you are in the country, it's tomorrow if you're on the West Coast. Michigan State, Kansas, followed by Duke, Kentucky. Also, they got the Progressive Legends Classic coming up November 20th. And some great matchups in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, including NC State, Michigan. How about the Kansas-Michigan State game, Sean, tomorrow night?
Now, Jeff Withy, one of those preseason Wooden Award candidates, had a great start to his season, 17-12-5. And I think that was the big question for Kansas, replacing Thomas Robinson, and how would Jeff Withy make that transition from being part of the wheel to being the main cog in the wheel down low? And he certainly showed up in game one, a tough test, though, coming up against Michigan State. And Sparty struggled over in Germany, especially from the outside, 23% shooting from behind the arc.
Yeah, congratulations to Kevin Ollie, the new coach of the UConn Huskies, at least for this year, getting that win as Pangos has one more free throw, 10 points in the game. Now, a lot of people are saying the Big Ten could be the best conference in college basketball this year with, you know, Michigan, Ohio State in the top five to start. What do you think?
Well, of course, in Indiana at number one, and Cody Zeller, the preseason favorite for that Wooden Award. I think from top to bottom, the Big Ten is the strongest conference in the country this year. I think Michigan State is going to only get better as the season goes on. I think even a team like Iowa can sneak up in that conference.
Foul on Bell of Gonzaga. The first on the Zags here in the half and his second personal. And obviously you know about Indiana, but we got Michigan in the top five. John Beilein, the former West Virginia coach there.
Trey Burke, Tim Hardaway Jr. a talented core of freshmen.
Got another Zags foul here. This one on Pangos. So it's three on him.
And this is where you got to be careful if you can Zag. Yeah, two fouls on this possession. Pangos goes to the bench. West Virginia still struggling, though, to put the ball in the hoop.
Yeah, I don't know how careful. I mean, I get what you're saying, but he got a 25-point lead on a team that scored 23 points and a 16 turnover. And another foul inside. That's three in 7 seconds. Three on Harris.
So similar to what we saw in the first half when the early fouls racked up against the Mountaineers. Now this time in the second half, they're going against the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
But this gives you a snapshot of what Gonzaga can be this year when a guy like Harris doesn't score in the first half, yet you got a big lead. Although West Virginia cutting into that lead with the three-point basket from Humphrey.
A bad place for Stockton to pick the ball up.
And a West Virginia foul now. 13 foul on the Mountaineers. And that's on Noreen, his third. Give the officials credit for being consistent.
Coach Huggins' team, a couple three-pointers here in the early stages of the second half.
Noreen pokes it away, but ends up in the hands of Harris. Harris spinning, can't score, but he's fouled. Kalichla picked up the foul. And free throws coming for Elias Harris.
And this is where Elias Harris has gotten a little bit better this year, attacking off the bounce with a purpose. He came in as a freshman, gained a lot of notoriety with his success, and he's been injured over the last two seasons. Maybe thought a little bit too much the type of moves he was making, where he was out on the floor this year. And talking with Elias, he says, I don't want to think this much. I just want to react and I want to play. And the preparation that he's put in the offseason has him set up and poised to have a huge senior season.
A very good rebounder, averaged close to 9 per game last year. And he can shoot it from outside. He didn't take a lot of threes, but shot 41%, made 29 of them over the course of the year. So about 1 per game. There's Kalichla, really hasn't given West Virginia much of anything tonight. Good drive there, aggressive to the bucket, but he couldn't get it to go. Humphrey keeps it alive, and now Hines pulls the trigger.
Humphrey's all over the floor right now.
His first game as a Mountaineer, transferring from Boston College. And a poor entry pass there. Turnover, Hines. Oh, beautiful move by Hines. That's a second time tonight off the pass. In one motion, he's gone up and put it in. This time he draws a foul. Stockton picks up his third. And we come back, a look at the Wendy's Wooden Watch, which includes Elias Harris.
Why not make lunch more than just lunch? With 2 times the points on dining in restaurants, you may find yourself asking, why not? A lot. Chase Sapphire Preferred. There's more to enjoy.
We use this board to compare car insurance rates side by side, so you get the same coverage, often for less.
It's one smart board. What else does it do? Reverse gravity?
Tell me about it.
Why am I not going anywhere?
You don't believe hard enough.
A smarter way to shop around. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
TV lets you see right into every NFL play. Add Bose sound and you can feel every NFL play with the Cinemate 1SR home theater speaker system. One speaker under your TV, one wireless base module that you can place almost anywhere, and you're immersed in sound. So watching every NFL moment feels more like you're a part of every NFL moment. Bose, game-changing sound.
Buy 5-Hour Energy pink lemonade, and you can help others along the way. A portion of every bottle.
bottle that they sell goes to fight breast cancer and to think that swell. The more you take, the more they'll pay to make them write a big check today. And if you're feeling a little slow, the 5-Hour Energy will help you go. So buy a bottle of pink lemonade. You can help fight breast cancer today.
Welcome back to the tip-off marathon. Elias Harris limited only 8 minutes in the first half. In the second half, 3 points already in the first four. An explosive player, 11 double-doubles a year ago. You see his numbers overall. A reason why, as we take a look at tonight's Wendy's Wooden Watch, brought to you by Wendy's. The season stats for a year ago, his improved shooting from the outside. And with all the pieces around him, Dave, Elias Harris is poised to be one of those guys that makes the cut on the wooden watch list as it progresses throughout the course of the season.
West Virginia on an 8-2 run over the last 2.5. And Caligula couldn't handle the rebound there, so it's Gonzaga ball. Well, you look at the lineup for the Bulldogs. You talked about the people around Harris. Now, this is one of the guys, obviously, Kevin Pangos, who is the leading returning scorer and an excellent three-point shooter. And Gary Bell improving his game. Wait till Karnowski gets some more action. Barring the transfer from Memphis, and Olynyk when he becomes eligible.
There's a small lineup for Mark Few out on the floor right now with Stockton, Pangos, and Bell, and they like the way they play together.
Strong move by Harris. Couldn't get it to go, but he was fouled. That's 4 on Noreen.
And they're giving him that on the shot.
Yeah, that's the second time that's happened where we've seen a blocking foul, and they have given 2 free throws to the Zag shooter. Happened in the first half as well.
I thought that one was on the floor and should be taken out underneath.
15 foul of West Virginia. Harris, 67% free throw shooter, and misses the first.
He had some groin issues earlier in the season, and it prevented him from really getting a fresh start even to this season. I mentioned some of his injury woes, whether it was a shoulder. He tweaked his Achilles 2 years ago against San Diego State, but primarily healthy right now. And he can be an explosive threat underneath. And especially with this lineup right now, they need him to show some toughness and grit.
Got 4 points, 4 rebounds. Gonzaga leading by 22, led by 27 at the half. Hines trying to drive on Pangos. Here's Staten. And the shot clock at 8. Gonzaga's played very good defensively tonight. Caligula, a nice move.
And Dower just bounced off the size of Caligula. And those are the type of moves, if you're a West Virginia fan, you want to see a lot more of during the course of this season.
His first field goal, and now a steal for Humphrey and the jam. And West Virginia's got it down to 18.
Eating away at the lead, little by little, 5 minutes in.
And that gets Mark Few up off the bench. Here's Harris, and a good screen set. Stockton and Harris at the 3.
And Caligula fatigued, maybe a little bit there, but didn't fight through that screen at all, and slow getting out to close out to Harris.
Hines stolen away. Stockton on the other end, and it's goaltending by Murray. Count the basket.
And Caligula being subbed out of the game, and just a lack of fight. Gary Bell, and then not getting through a screen by David Stockton. And that's Caligula and his size. 260 plus pounds getting picked off by David Stockton, who
shouldn't
weighs about 160.
Yeah, shouldn't happen. Got an offensive foul. That's on Murray. 6th team foul in West Virginia. 2nd personal on Murray. And the Mountaineers have almost 2 weeks off before they play again, you would think, you know, Bob Huggins would love to have more game action. And he's watched these guys enough in practice. The three transfers he saw last year, he wants them to get some chemistry on the court in games.
We mentioned this part of the Old Spice Classic doesn't affect the bracket at all. And these two teams could actually match up again in Orlando.
In fact, West Virginia could actually have a game against Oklahoma coming up, which would technically be a non-league game, even though now they're both in the Big 12. And we'll play each other twice during the regular season. Here's the Old Spice Classic bracket. Tonight's game doesn't actually impact the bracket or the outcome of the event, which is November 22nd through the 25th. You can see it on ESPN, ESPN2.
Davidson part of that field. Of course, they're coming up next against New Mexico. Damon Brooks, Southern Conference Player of the Year a year ago, 24 points in the opener for Davidson, who always has a couple of shooters on the outside for Coach McKillop.
Great way to start the marathon, too, with two of the loudest venues in college basketball here in Gonzaga and then at the Pit up next. Three-pointer, Pangos buries it. Two-pointer, foot on the line. But a 25-point lead for the Zags. And a 7-0 run. The first two for Pangos, his other two baskets triple.
And that's where he's dangerous. In transition. I mean, he can catch and shoot from anywhere on the floor, but the transition three is where Kevin Pangos has thrived. And of course, last year, Dave Pass, you were here. You saw it with Doris Burke as Kevin Pangos introduced himself to the college basketball landscape.
This is the NCAA tournament game from last year. Gonzaga, West Virginia. Pangos was good in that game as well. So was Bell. But to your point, last year in the tip-off marathon, when they beat Washington State, not a lot of people outside of the Gonzaga program knew about Kevin Pangos, but he hit 9 threes, 9 of 16 from behind the arc, scored 33 points in that game against the Cougars.
Well, and I think the big question for Gonzaga coming into this season is leadership. Robert Sacre was, without question, their emotional and vocal leader a year ago. And when talking with Kevin Pangos, he felt his time around the Canadian national team program this summer really benefited him a great deal. Hanging around Steve Nash and Corey Joseph and so many guys that have now gone from Canada into the NBA, he just learned and absorbed. He said, I didn't say a whole lot. I didn't have to say a whole lot. Nash didn't have to tell me a lot about how to be a leader. But what I did was observe Steve Nash and the way that he was able to control and dictate what was going on the floor. And you couldn't help but soak that in.
You know, and Mark Few, obviously very good X's and O guy, but also his evaluation of talent and his staff when they recruit, considering they got players from all over the world on this roster, and that's the norm for Gonzaga in terms of how they get their players. Good hustle by Pangos, but touched it last. It'll stay West Virginia ball.
Well, you mentioned his coaching staff from Mark Few. Tommy Lloyd does a lot of that international recruiting. Ray Giacoletti, a superb job with their interior post presence, head coaching experience at Utah.
Good defense there by Gonzaga, forces West Virginia to call a timeout.
And of course, Donnie Daniels as well. Former head coach, assistant coach at UCLA for their final four runs, a very experienced group underneath him.
Well, here's what you're talking about from this time last year to tip off. A great 24 hours of basketball. Kevin Pangos, 9 3-pointers.
Just a sensational release. You look at all these shots. His footwork, he's set, he's ready to go up. His release is very tight. And in transition, you'll see Kevin Pangos as he pushes up, surveys the defense. A couple guys back, no worries. He's got that in the bag.
Got 13 points tonight, 3 assists. He averaged 3.5 assists per game last year.
You think about Gonzaga right now, 7 of 12 from behind the arc, 58% from three-point range, 50% from the field. Their ability to score in a variety of ways and then defend you makes them a dangerous team. And you asked me earlier, how good can this team be? I think the sky is the limit for the Gonzaga Bulldogs. They've long waited for a run to the Final Four, and this team, with its depth, has that kind of potential.
Last year they finished second in their league, lost to St. Mary's. It ended a string of 11 consecutive WCC regular season titles. They also lost the WCC tournament championship game. Still made it to the NCAA tournament as an at-large. Offensive foul is called. Contact between Pangos and Noreen, who's playing with four fouls, and that's now four on Pangos.
And Noreen, that's what he does for West Virginia. And they really missed him a lot down the stretch of the regular season a year ago when he broke his leg at Pitt. They ended up going 4-9 down the rest of the regular season after starting the season 15-5.
Through the hands of Humphrey, almost another turnover by West Virginia. They've done a little bit better job protecting the ball in the second half. Only three turnovers since intermission after 15 in the first half. It was a 27-point Gonzaga lead at the end of one half of play. Got a foul underneath, and it's going to be on the Zags. 25-point lead for the home team.
Aerosmith, music from another dimension. The band's first studio album of all new songs in 11 years. Aerosmith, music from another dimension. Available now.
Rated M for mature.
NBA superstars headline a Wednesday night doubleheader. First, it's Memphis versus OKC as reigning scoring king Kevin Durant looks to throw down against a hungry Grizz squad. Then, the defending champs stomp into L.A. Miami's Big Four is finding its groove.
Nice pass.
But will CP3 and Blake steal the show? Grizzlies Thunder at 8 Eastern. Heat Clippers at 10:30. Presented by State Farm. Wednesday on ESPN.
This can't be happening.
Of course it's not happening. Armored car. Listen, having money isn't about luck. Make your own coffee, save $1,000 a year. Feed me.
Feed the pig.
Every Sunday, watching NFL Red Zone on Xfinity from Comcast is like having the best seat in the house.
You're right in the action.
Because with NFL Red Zone, you see all the top plays from around the league.
Just amazing.
As they happen, including every touchdown from every game.
Touchdown!
Sunday afternoons.
Yeah! Yeah!
This is the NFL on Xfinity. This is awesome. Sign up for the sports entertainment package to get NFL Red Zone and more for just $9.99 more a month. Call 1-800-XFINITY today.
You're looking live at the Tip-Off Social Hub. This is Mission Control for all things social. Join the conversation on Twitter. Go to @ESPNCBB. Tip-Off Marathon. 24 hours, everything social surrounding the Tip-Off Marathon will be observed, followed, and amplified from this hub. Again, hashtag Tip-Off Marathon. You also have @SeanFarnum, @DavePash. If you want to tweet us individually, and I guarantee you, Farnum will respond. Because he tweets nonstop.
What are you saying
now, aren't you?
I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention to a word you were saying, Dave Pash. I'm too busy tweeting that Dave Pash is talking about Twitter right now.
He will respond to you folks if you tweet him. Not just about college basketball either, but of course all the great stuff going on in this next 24 hours. He's going to be up for all of it. So you can get him and Fraschilla. I guarantee you Fraschilla will be up also for the next 24 hours
and
tweets as well.
Go to sleep. You've got three games at the Tip-Off Marathon. Why are you still up tweeting right now, Fran?
Well, his wake-up call's in an hour. So why bother sleeping at this point? And I'm not kidding when I say that you will stay up for the next 22 hours. We are entering hour number three here in about 10 minutes.
There'll be a lot of great games in this Tip-Off Marathon. Xavier Butler, one of the ones I'm looking forward to. Both teams in the Atlantic 10 this year. And Butler struggled to shoot the ball from the perimeter a year ago. Brad Stevens' team gets a big, big boost with Rodney Clark, the transfer from Arkansas.
With all of the realignment, obviously West Virginia in the Big 12, as we have a tie-up here. Unless they call it foul. There's a tie-up. West Virginia in the Big 12. Butler, the A-10. You have A&M in Missouri in the SEC now.
And VCU also in the A-10 now. A lot of realignment, a lot of different schedules. And people forget these schedules have been made out for well over a year, sometimes 2 years in advance, which is why you can have a matchup like we have in the tip-off marathon between two teams that'll be playing in the A-10 this year.
Got a foul inside. Actually, it looked like a flop. This is the NBA. Right now, Kevin Noreen would be getting a warning. Did you see that? Noreen bumped into Karnowski, and Karnowski didn't do anything, but just got called for his fourth foul. Watch this here.
Not a lot there.
Man, both, guys, contact
both, guys, but both guys are initiating the contact from it again.
Yeah, but the third time, that was totally a flop. 1-1 for Noreen. First point of the night for Noreen, who's really been battling injuries in his tenure at West Virginia. Had the broken ankle last year in January. Took a medical red shirt 2 years ago with a knee injury. Harris on the baseline, close to a push off, but instead Noreen picks up his fifth. Seventeen foul on West Virginia. Noreen fouls out with 2 points, no rebounds.
Frustrating night for the Mountaineers.
But knowing Bob Huggins and his coaching staff, which, by the way, includes Ron Everhart, who was the head coach at Duquesne, but he's back in his home state of West Virginia. His first year as an assistant on the staff. There's Ron. Now, this is a good group, and they'll get West Virginia playing better come conference time.
Well, a great story about Ron Everhart and Coach Huggins, and where their relationship actually began was when Coach Huggins was playing at West Virginia. Ron Everhart used to go and rebound. He lived about 15 miles away from Morgantown. He'd drive up and rebound for Coach Huggins in the gym. And so when Coach Huggins had an opening spot on his staff and he became available after Duquesne, his tenure at Duquesne came to a close, there was an immediate call for Coach Huggins to bring him back home to West Virginia.
Joins a pretty good staff that includes Eric Martin and associate head coach Larry Harrison.
And what they ask is they ask their guys to compete, and we've even seen that here in the second half. There's not a lot of positives you're going to take away, but this is a team that hasn't given up in this game. They haven't gone away. They are trying to fight back and scratch and claw, and as the season progresses, they're going to get better. That is a staple of a Bob Huggins coach basketball team.
Well, and if they don't, those three-hour practices are going to become 4 hours. Apologize there for, again, some technical difficulties with the audio. 10.5 remaining. 58-34. Gonzaga on top of West Virginia. Zags playing their second game of the year. They beat Southern Utah in their opener. This is West Virginia's opener. A new era of Mountaineer basketball playing in the Big 12 and then trying to get the newcomers up to speed. Three transfers in the starting lineup. Two from the Atlantic 10, one from the ACC. Elandrietti is fouled. That's the 18th foul on West Virginia. And an Eric Murray, one of those transfers coming over from LaSalle, gets his third personal foul.
And a great move by Elandrietti to pressure release from the denial of the Mountaineers. And Mark Few told his team yesterday, when you back cut, there is no fake back cutting in this game. And when you read that over, they're overplaying you. You backdoor and you go all the way through. And that time, Elandrietti made sure he followed that rule that Coach Few required of his guys and asked of him yesterday.
14th year for Mark Few as the head coach. 24th overall was an assistant under Dan Munson here. before getting the head job. Obviously, he's had opportunities to go elsewhere, but he loves it in Spokane. And the fans here at Gonzaga are glad that he stayed. Certainly one of the best in the business, and that winning percentage of 79% shows that. I know he's playing in the WCC, not playing in a power conference, but there's some good teams in this league. And he's had some success in the NCAA tournament as Kalichula gets the stuff.
Well, the WCC and the brand of basketball has dramatically improved.
Yes.
And the landscape has changed with BYU and St. Mary's. But the thing that impressed me most is Mark Few, every single season, schedules one of the more difficult non-conference schedules in the country. He doesn't duck anybody. He'll play you anywhere at any time. And games like this help the team prepare for March.
Eddie hits a three. That's 10 points now, his first triple of the game. Gonzaga started 1 of 12 from the field. They are 19 of 27 since then. Meanwhile, West Virginia shooting under 30% for the game.
Oh, we need Gary, God damn it.
9 minutes remaining, 26-point lead for the Zags. And contact out on the perimeter, the foul called on Henderson, his second. 19 fouls, so 1-1 coming up for Stockton. Now, how difficult it must be for David Stockton, obviously with his dad, John, and growing up in Spokane, playing at the school where his dad played, where his dad comes to all the games and is very involved in the university. But it shows you how close they are as father and son, and the relationship they have and the type of young man that David is to take on that challenge.
Well, he plays with a great deal of maturity, a great deal of poise, and has only improved over the last season and a half. I mean, he's really begun to have a defined role on this team where you can't keep him off the court. And he's earned that right to be out there.
You see the leadership, too. He's doing a lot of talking on defense here in the zone. Three-pointer on the way from Humphrey. Brown got the rebound and foul. That's on Guy Landrietti. Tomorrow night on ESPN2, coverage of women's college basketball tips off between two top 10 teams at 6. All-American Brittany Griner, defending champion Bears, begin their run at back-to-back titles, taking on Kentucky Tuesday 6 on ESPN2. Terrific season for Baylor a year ago, and they're going to be tough to beat in 2012-2013.
Well, in that matchup in particular, Kentucky actually ended the Gonzaga women's team run in the NCAA tournament last year in Rhode Island. But Brittany Griner is a difference maker without question. If you've watched college basketball at all, men's or women's, you know the impact that she has had on the game and how she has taken Baylor to the top of the mountaintop. You think about her and Skylar Diggins, the point guard from Notre Dame, from Muffet McGraw. And Elena Deladon from Delaware. Those are the big three in women's college basketball this season.
Obviously, it'll be different without Pat Summitt in Tennessee. And the Lady Vols lost the other night, Chattanooga. Eddie with the bucket. And it's 64-37 Gonzaga. 12 points for Eddie. Under 8 to go in game 1 of 16 on the ESPN networks. Up next from the pit, New Mexico and a very good Davidson team. Kalichla off the mark. Hustling down court, though, to get in position to defend Harris.
You mentioned New Mexico, Steve Alford's team.
Harris takes it to the goal and is fouled. Kalichla picks up the personal, his third.
Understanding your offense, your strengths and weaknesses. Guy Landrietti, one of the best slashers on the West Coast. And in the 24-hour tip-off marathon, goes down the lane, and it's a blow-by. Easy finish. It's been a good night for the Bulldogs.
Why not make lunch more than just lunch? With 2 times the points on dining in restaurants, you may find yourself asking, why not? A lot. Jay Sapphire Preferred. There's more to enjoy.
You want to win? You need logistics.
We play a complicated game.
We have over 200 plays in our playbook.
That's a lot of plays. We play an up-tempo, no-huddle offense. Go, go, go. We snap the ball every 13 seconds. Inside zone, outside zone, counter, draw, simple patterns, dozens of options. Score, score, and score some more. Fans go nuts. A second saved here is an extra yard there. To win, you need speed, precision, execution, and teamwork. In other words, logistics. That's how you win.
My name is Maddie. I have a really busy life. I travel. I volunteer a lot. I run marathons. It is difficult to carve out time to date, so I joined Match.
One in five relationships now begin on an online dating site.
Hi!
How are you?
What is a marathon? 26?
26.2 miles.
Yeah. Anybody can run 26.
Yeah,
it's the last. 0.2,
it really kills you.
Match.com. More dates, more relationships, and more marriages than any other site. Start for free today.
Programming update for you. Tony Snell, New Mexico. They are set to tip off over on ESPNU. That game will start at 2:05 Eastern time, all part of our 24-hour tip-off marathon. Up on the social media circles, ESPN CBB and hashtag tip-off marathon, guys.
Now, tomorrow or tonight, depending on where you are, ESPN has four championship coaches headlining the State Farm Champions Classic from the Georgia Dome at 7. Tom Izzo in Michigan State, Bill Self in Kansas. Then Coach K, Coach Calipari, Duke, Kentucky at 9 on ESPN. That's a picture there of Tom Izzo. You could take that at any game. Obviously one of the more intense coaches in college basketball, coming off a loss to Connecticut on Friday.
But a beautiful way to start off the college basketball season. Of course, we had all those great games on Friday, 124 games on Friday. But the 24-hour tip-off marathon, you get to see so many teams, as you mentioned, from so many different states as we enter hour three. St. John's and Detroit, Steve Lavin, cancer-free, back on the sideline for St. John's. And Detroit, one of the most talented players in the country, and Ray McCallum Jr., talented point guard, 22 points, 6 assists, and 5 rebounds in their opener. So many great games to look forward to.
And great to hear, too, about Coach Lab, that he's doing well. Guy you played for at UCLA, one of our former colleagues here at ESPN. And obviously a couple years ago had a great run with St. John's in the Big East and struggled last year with a young team. Mike Dunlap, one of his obviously key assistants now coaching in the NBA, got the head job of the Charlotte Bobcats. Gonzaga led by 27 at the half. West Virginia's played better here in the second half, but unable to dig out of that huge hole. 15 first half turnovers and only 18 points. They've already had more scoring here in the second half through almost 13 minutes, and they added 20. Harris with the backside board off the miss from Aaron Brown. And shortly, Davidson in New Mexico will tip off, and that game will start in ESPNU. We'll get you right out to the pit, and we're done here on ESPN. Another Kalichla foul on the inside is fourth.
Jake Cohen's ability to shoot the three, this big 6'10" fixture for Davidson and Coach McKillop. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon on the call down there at the pit. The Snake will be there. Of course, one of the most famous or infamous fans of the Lobos. And Tony Snell, his ability to score. What he worked on most in the offseason, though, was his rebounding ability. He knows he has to do a little bit more for Coach Alford this year. I look forward to getting back to the hotel and watching that contest and seeing Tony's growth. The Mountain West Conference is going to be very strong this year. San Diego State, although they took the loss to Syracuse, UNLV, a very deep and talented team for Coach Rice in his second season.
Did you say the Snake? That's you speak his, from experience?
That's his nickname, yes. I've been to the pit. I've met Snake. Somebody will tweet him right now and tell him he just got a mention, and he'll be excited about it.
Entry pass to Kalichla. Way off the mark for that one. 6.5 remaining. You know, Gonzaga, we talked a lot about their offense tonight. 53% shooting, but
The Zags have played outstanding defense, half court and full court. You surprised that Gonzaga still has starters on the floor and a 30-point game? It's early in the year, just trying to get a minutes.
Get in rhythm, get in the flow. And there's different combinations that have been out there, though. I mean, we've seen lineups with three guards. Now we see a lineup where Stockton is the lead guard, Bell Jr.
Three-pointer from Brown, no good, but he was fouled. He'll shoot three. A great way to watch the tip-off marathon and college basketball throughout the year. Watch ESPN app. You can also check it out at watchespn.com. College basketball available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone. It's a great resource for us at ESPN in preparing for games. Great resource as a fan and watching games as well.
Well, you and I often are in airports, traveling around the country. The opportunity to dial in to any of the games on the network allows us to get ahead sometimes in our preparation. I used it yesterday. We landed here in Spokane in order to watch North Carolina, because I've got North Carolina coming up on Friday in their flyover game from Maui against Long Beach State.
Gary Bell will go to the bench. 15 points and 4 assists for the Zags. And Brown gets the third free throw to drop. And West Virginia hits the 40-point mark. Inside 6 minutes to go. West Virginia still hustling on D, but Harris is fouled by Caliccia, and he's gone. Second Mountaineer to foul out. And Harris will go to the free throw line. Was 4 of 8 so far at the line tonight.
A tough night for Caliccia. 2 of 6 shooting from the floor. 5 personal fouls, 5 points, 5 rebounds. And he's going to have a lot better nights than he had tonight. I think the size and the speed and the quickness and the way that they collapsed on the interior made it very difficult for him from the start.
Now Harris gets the first free throw. Davidson and New Mexico tipping off on ESPNU. And when our game is done here in Spokane, we'll get you to Albuquerque for the remainder of that game on ESPN. Harris with now 11 points, all coming since intermission. And Gonzaga leads it 70-40. Brown on the drive. A follow won't go. As Eric Murray tried to stuff it through, but he was fouled and will go to the free throw line.
And you mentioned Harris's numbers here in the second half. Those first half numbers limited because of only 8 minutes of playing time due to the foul trouble that he got into. He picked up 2 early fouls and had to go to the bench.
Virginia. You know, we see a lot of time shots of Bob Huggins upset with his team, upset with his players, and certainly we have tonight. But and his practices are hard. But at the same time, I think the moment that really encapsulated it was the Final Four 2010. Deshaun Butler, yep, who's now a grad assistant at West Virginia, when he had that knee injury. Just Huggins showing his love for his player and just how Butler and the rest of the team responds to Huggins. And that's a big reason why Huggs has had such a terrific 31-year run as a head coach at several stops.
So much of it is about relationships. And there's no way you go through 31 years and you have the success that Coach Huggins has had with players like Deshaun Butler without having your players believe and fully understand how you coach, why you coach them that way, and know that you have their best interest and that you have an undying love for them. And Coach Huggins has proven that time and time again.
And Butler hoping that he can get healthy enough where he still can play. He wants a shot still in the NBA and believes that that's a dream that can happen for him. And Giddens gets in the lane and puts it in. 30-point lead again for the Zags. 4.5 to go.
Grant Giddens, two-time Idaho State Player of the Year, Gatorade State Player of the Year, redshirted last year, and really gained a lot from that experience, learning how to play at the Division I level. He's got some good savvy, as we saw there, putting the ball on the floor and getting to the rim.
Heading into the lane, draws contact and a foul on Murray. His fourth. Now this Gonzaga team going to be interesting to watch as the season unfolds, because their ranking and where they are right now is kind of where they were at the beginning of last year. They looked really good early in the season, up and down. Obviously the league was very good last year with St. Mary's winning the WCC. They play such a tough schedule that they're battle-tested come NCAA tournament time. They made it to the third round last year, beating West Virginia in the second round. They lost to Ohio State in round three a season ago.
I think when you look at this schedule and you look at the potential roadblocks ahead, they get Clemson in the opening round, as we showed you earlier in the Old Spice Classic, when they get down to Florida. And they get the winner or loser, depending upon what happens in that first round game, Oklahoma, UTEP. Potential matchup with Davidson, West Virginia in the finals. Who knows how that bracket will unfold. But you've got games against Illinois, game against Kansas State in the battle in Seattle over the winter break. They've got Baylor. They've got Oklahoma State on New Year's Eve. This is going to be a tested team by the time they get to the West Coast Conference. And that leaves out, by the way, a trip to Indianapolis against Butler.
Not an official timeout here. You mentioned Kansas State. Obviously, each year there are many coaching changes. Bob Huggins used to work at K-State. You got Bruce Weber, the former Illinois coach now in Manhattan. Frank Martin going to South Carolina his first year with the Gamecocks.
And Roddy Magruder, one of the better players in the Big 12 for Kansas State. That cupboard is not left bare.
West Virginia now in the same league as Kansas State. Mountaineers picked to finish sixth in the Big 12, leaving the Big East after 17 years. Obviously, Syracuse, Pitt, and Notre Dame will soon follow, but they're going to the ACC from the Big East. 3:52 to go. Gonzaga in command.
The clean energy revolution is underway. Where will the power come from to keep it going? Like all revolutions, it will depend on people. People with passion. People with innovation. People with the power to literally change the world. Clean energy jobs are out there, and we're giving people the power to go get them. Ecotech Institute, the first and only college focused on careers in renewable energy. You have the power. Make the world your workplace.
TV lets you see right into every NFL play. Add Bose sound and you can feel every NFL play with the Cinemate 1SR home theater speaker system. One speaker under your TV, one wireless base module that you can place almost anywhere, and you're immersed in sound. So watching every NFL moment feels more like you're a part of every NFL moment. Bose, game-changing sound.
New Pink Lemonade 5-Hour Energy? 5-Hour Energy supports the Avon Foundation for Women Breast Cancer Crusade. So I can get the energized feeling I need and support a great cause? I'm sold.
Pink Lemonade 5-Hour Energy.
Yeah, and a portion of every sale goes to the Avon Foundation for Women Breast Cancer Crusade.
I'm sold.
New Pink Lemonade 5-Hour Energy. Get the alert, energized feeling you need and support breast cancer research and access to care.
College basketball is back on ESPN with the State Farm Champions Classic. Four of the nation's premier programs rumble in Atlanta. First, returning big man Jeff Withey leads powerhouse Kansas against the stacked Michigan State squad. Then two heavyweight coaches go head-to-head when Coach K's Blue Devils take on the defending national champion Wildcats. The State Farm Champions Classic. Michigan State, Kansas at 7 Eastern. Duke, Kentucky at 9. tonight on ESPN.
Gonzaga about to improve to 104-7 at McCarthy Athletic Center since it opened in the 2004-2005 season. Tonight's player of the game brought to you by Old Spice, Gary Bell Jr., a game-high 15 points.
It's not only about his offense when you look at Gary Bell and the way that he can score, slashing to the rim, shooting it from the outside, the mid-range teardrop shot. That's actually one that he's developed during the course of the offseason, but his overall awareness, his basketball IQ, his toughness at the defensive end of the floor, these are all things that are important for Gonzaga to have a great run this season. And Gary Bell Jr., underrated a year ago, kind of lost because of Pangos' performance on the tip-off marathon. And this year, people are going to be talking about Gary Bell Jr.
Yeah, Bell really came alive in the NCAA tournament last year, averaged 16 points per game in the NCAAs, 10 points per game during the regular season, and led all freshmen in three-point shooting last year at 48%, was ninth overall in the country. Coming up next, we'll go to the Pit, New Mexico and Davidson. You can see it live over on ESPNU and on the Watch ESPN app, watchespn.com. And we'll get you to the Pit here on ESPN shortly. As with time running down on the shot clock, Eric Murray puts it in. He's got 10 points. First Mountaineer in double figures. That's only the 13th basket of the game. But as the season goes on and Murray and the other transfers get accustomed to playing with the holdovers for West Virginia to get more game action, you would expect the Mountaineers to improve. Barham for three, won't go. And Miles grabbed the rebound and was fouled.
Barham a little slow getting up. He took some contact to the face, and he already had a broken nose in which they had to re-break to set for him, which is why you can see him with the mask.
See, the guy went over to him. Stockton went over to make sure he's okay. Stockton, one that gave him the broken nose, inadvertent elbow, in practice a couple weeks ago. There, Eric Murray was trying to box out Barham.
Keaton Miles at the free throw line, started 30 of 32 games a season ago. Plays with that toughness, that physical nature that you like to see at the defensive end of the floor, hoping to take a step forward at the offensive end this year. Limited score a year ago, and only averaging slightly over a point a game.
And that's his first point of this game. Does have five rebounds and a couple of assists for West Virginia as Barham is over on the Gonzaga bench. And having that nose looked at by the Zags training staff. Miles gets the second free throw. A timeout here. Perhaps not an injury, perhaps a contact issue instead for Barham. Take a look at some of your burning questions.
A 4-5, the burning questions that I have. Can the West rebound? I think a lot of that's going to be put on the shoulders of Arizona and UCLA. They kind of lift up the rest of the Pac-12 with them, but with Gonzaga, UNLV, San Diego State, pretty strong. The Big Ten is as good as advertised. I'm really looking forward to seeing this conference grow throughout the course of the year. Kansas in the Big 12, dominating time and year in and year out. Baylor going to be their most difficult test in that one. Of course, Kentucky, can they do it with another talented young group of players? These are the questions that are coming in my mind as we start the college basketball season.
It's not just the fact that you lose five guys, you lose the best player in college basketball too. Anthony Davis, the number one pick in the draft, who was so dominant on the defensive end, but obviously was a very good offensive player as well. So I know you got to replace the five guys, but that's obviously the one big one in Anthony Davis.
It's going to take Noel, I think, a little while to kind of acclimate and get into that role that people anticipate him coming in as the nation's top recruit from a year ago.
And you talk about the mid-majors, so to speak. South Alabama already with an upset, beating Florida State. We'll have those in November and December.
Yep.
Question is, will we have them in March? Back door. Grangettis puts it in, and Miles fouled him. Three-point opportunity.
Miles not happy. But this is kind of showing you a little bit of the depth that Gonzaga has. And Grangettis with a beautiful backdoor cut absorbs the contact and able to finish up over the top.
I think you also appreciate the reactions that we've seen from the West Virginia players. They're not happy. They know that this has been embarrassing, but they continue to play hard. And with some of the calls that they have in liked, or when they've been upset with their own errors, they've been pretty demonstrative. So is Coach Huggins.
Yeah, Coach Huggins up on the bench, clapping, encouraging his team still down the stretch here. This is a long season. This win, this loss, it doesn't define either team's year. It's a good start and obviously a positive start for the Gonzaga Bulldogs, but you can't rest after game two of your season if you're Gonzaga, and certainly game one doesn't upend and ruin any dreams and visions you have in Morgantown.
The development of Karnofsky will be something to watch for Gonzaga as he's down low and puts it in.
Well, Karnofsky gets the finish, but what a beautiful read and a great touch pass by David Stockton.
Henderson for three. Karnofsky didn't really jump, but got the rebound.
He's so big and eats up so much space, he doesn't really have to do all that much to get a rebound.
Down court, Staten and Murray with the jam. 12 points for Murray, a team high. Hines the next man in the box score with 9 points and 7 for Gary Brown. Here's Murray again, giving 14. Approaching a minute to go.
Oh, your whistle!
And a good save by Michael Hart. Barn for three. And rebounded by Aaron Harris, freshman from Indianapolis. Now Gonzaga blows out West Virginia. It was over pretty early. Even though the Zags were 1 of 12 to start the game, West Virginia couldn't even get field goal attempts. They turned the ball over so much in the first 5 or 6 minutes. The Zags got out to a 15-point lead 7 or 8 minutes into the first half, and it was pretty much over.
18-1 differential at the half in points off the turnovers, and that second half of the game in the perimeter shooting by pretty much everybody tonight. Mike Hart with 8 as they continue to stretch from the outside and create issues. Now over 60% shooting from 3-point range for the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
This game's over, but our night and morning and yours as well, far from over. We still got 21 plus hours of college basketball for you. 15 more games coming up. We'll send you to the pit in Albuquerque for Davidson and New Mexico. A really good game coming up on ESPN next. West Virginia commits a foul with 5.8 on the clock.
A great start to the season for the Gonzaga Bulldogs, and I think this is they showed a little bit of a sampling of why I think this team can make a Final Four run, an Elite Eight Final Four run for Mark Few. But the potential is there, the growth is there. Karnofsky, as you mentioned, I think is going to be one of those keys as they get into the late season, as they get into the NCAA tournament. How much growth has he developed, or will he develop, between now and March?
Hard at the free throw line. And Gonzaga letting Ram Backamas, a freshman from Longview, Washington, get a few seconds on the court. West Virginia had just 18 points at the half. And the Mountaineers will finish with 50 as Gonzaga wins by 34. A complete game on both ends of the court for Mark Few's team. For Sean Farnham, I'm Dave Pasch. So long from Spokane, Washington. Up next, it's Davidson and New Mexico in progress. And we send you there now to the pit. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon. Fellas.
We do welcome you here to the pit in Albuquerque, and you're reading that score correctly. Davidson 22, New Mexico 6. What a start for the Wildcats. Tony Snell with a much needed bucket for New Mexico. It has been all Davidson so far. Game two of our tip-off marathon. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon with you, but an answer at this end, Clint Mann.
Clint Mann must have worked on his three-point shot over the offseason, because last year, Clint Mann attempted four threes and made zero. He's already attempted three tonight and made two.
So he's hit a couple of threes. He didn't hit one all of last year. Davidson with the 25-9 lead on the road. And a foul against the Wildcats will send us to a timeout. It's rocking here past midnight at the Pit, but the Wildcats have the big lead.
This life is not an easy one. I've made powerful enemies.
Do you think what happened to you was an accident?
If you want the truth, come and get it.
The Amazing Spider-Man, now on Blu-ray Combo Pack.
Show me the Carfax.
We've got receipts from the previous owner.
Whoa.
At a car wash.
Tire shine.
You want to see the accidents and service records reported to Carfax and a price based on the car's history. Show me the Carfax. Ask your dealer or go to Carfax.com.
State Farm presents the 2012 Seattle Auto Show.
Show me new. Show me cool. Show me green. Show me everything in between.
The Seattle Auto Show. 5 days only. November 14th through 18th. CenturyLink Field Event Center.
The driver helper position is for someone who likes to work outdoors in any sort of weather, someone that can work in a fast-paced environment. I'd work 5 days per week, Monday through Friday. This great holiday cash. You meet the driver typically in your own community. Your driver sets expectations for you, and you follow through with what they're looking for. There's really no questions to ask. You're on the truck, you deliver the package, you get back on and do it again.
State Farm presents the 2012 Seattle Auto Show.
Show me new. Show me cool. Show me green. Show me everything in between.
The Seattle Auto Show. 5 days only. November 14th through 18th. CenturyLink Field Event Center.
Well, it is hour number three of ESPN's college basketball tip-off marathon. We're here inside the Pit, one of the great venues in college hoops in Albuquerque, New Mexico. So far, though, Davidson out to the big early lead. They lead the Lobos 25-9. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon here inside the Pit. And we figured we had a reason for you to stay up late night with us. Two really good teams with big expectations for this season. But so far, Miles, it's been all Davidson.
It has been all Davidson. Davidson's come out with a lot of poise, a lot of confidence. They're a veteran team that's not afraid to play in tough atmospheres and in big games. And you see early on, they really share the basketball. Cherepovich gets off the three-point shot off the ball reversal. Then DeMond Brooks, the player of the year in the SoCon last year, takes advantage of the size advantage down low. And then Clint Mann has been the man early in this game, knocking down two threes, 11 points already off the bench.
Well, Davidson, their success last year blitzed through the Southern Conference and made it back to the NCAA tournament. They gave Louisville a real run in the round of 64 before falling. Louisville, of course, advanced to the Final Four. There's Alex Kirk, the big man who can step out and shoot. The Lobos maybe starting to get into an offensive rhythm now.
Kirk's a guy that they'll need production from all season long. He redshirted last year after having surgery on a herniated disc.
Nick Cochran gives it up. And Jake Cohen back in the game, starting big man for the Wildcats. Cohen can shoot from the outside, launches a three, and the rebound tipped back to Cochran. He'll shoot the three, no good. Williams on the move, had it poked away, but maintained control.
Davidson did a great job of getting back in transition defense, getting five guys to the paint there to surround Williams.
Snell just had to go right through his hands. Turnover, Lobos. Steve Alford, the sixth-year head coach, longtime head coach. But this is his sixth year here in New Mexico. He's had great success with the Lobos. Six times he's taken a team to the NCAA tournament. Last year with New Mexico, he expects to get there again.
And they were the only team in the final poll last year from the West that ended up ranked. And that includes all the teams in the Pac-12 and San Diego State, St. Mary's, Gonzaga.
Cohen got three underneath and used the glass to score.
Davidson has some of the best ball and player movement that you're going to see. They reverse that ball. When a guy is open, they throw it to him right away with no hesitation. Great back cut.
open. And he rattles that one on. So Alex Kurt looking smooth offensively. Yeah, he missed all of last year with back surgery. He's back and expected to be a big contributor. Clint Mann switched hands, couldn't get it to go.
Look at Kirk, he's dead tired. He can barely get up the floor now, Dave. They're going to need a sub for him. Maybe Greenwood's coming in.
At the moment, they've got two big men on the floor, which doesn't happen all that often. Kendall Williams, some sloppy ball handling, draws a foul. And bailed out a bit there. Miles was talking about the half-court offense for Davidson.
Well, there's the ball reversal. Starts on the left side. Easy touch pass. Nice back screen there on Kirk. Easy lay-in for Cohen. You have to bump that back screener once Kirk gets hung up there, or an automatic late emergency switch.
Experienced team. Everybody coming back. A coach who's been at this school, in this program for 24 years. It may be game number two for Davidson, but a well-schooled team.
Coach McKillop was raving about his team. He loves the veterans, their leadership. He loves the interchangeable parts that they have. Guys who can play multiple positions, defend multiple positions, also on the defensive end.
Linda Williams made both free throws. Clint Mann had to come out of the game. Mann has two personal fouls already. It's Williams who will take a seat. So Alex Kirk is staying out there. Big man looked a little tired on the last Lobos possession.
Well, I think the reason that Alford goes now with the two bigs is because they were getting a little bit hurt on the glass. You want to make sure he has some size in there to match up with Cohen and Brooks.
Here's Brooks, natural lefty, too strong, crashes the offensive glass hard and creates the jump ball. It will be Lobos' ball, though, with the possession arrow. What an atmosphere we have. It's past midnight here in Albuquerque, but they sold more than 14.